Alrighty, and we are live and we are late. I'm so sorry, y'all. We're just trying to get ourselves ready. But here we are. Welcome back to another episode of Candlekeep Mysteries and the Sealed Pages of Verglas. We are the Rollets of Fate, and we are super excited to be here with you. Unfortunately, we had a few casualties, as you can see. We don't have a Lucky, we don't have a Mark, and we don't have a Mo, but yeah, that
They
one
didn't
is.
die.
That you know of.
Well, let's just say the prayer for them as well as for the savage journey to the
Like,
internet gods. Who knows?
maybe
There
two of their
you
social lives, but that's like childcare reasons.
go. I am Cisco Blanco, your Tailweaver and Chaos Coordinator, and alongside me, I have one of the greatest online tables in the world, even with an extra guest star today, Candlekeep's Priciest Meat Popsicles. Could you please, friends, introduce
Oh
yourselves and
my
your
God.
characters? Popcorn Andy.
No, I refuse. I refuse. You know who I am at this point.
Come
You know what I'm
on,
about.
meat popsicle. Come on, that was good.
You'll deny the fans, Andy.
Andy, Bruce Moonbeer, Barbarian, Dash of Cleric, Half Orc, level 12.
Damn, amazing.
Ross, go.
Well, thanks. We haven't met me yet, so I'll be playing a new character called Flair, who I'm not going to give any more about. But I'm also level 12, which will come in helpful. Joey, off you.
All right. So my name's Joey. I am playing a Horizon Walker Ranger Wood Elf named Erald Emmerfield, and I'm also level 12 as well. Luke, go ahead while you're in the middle of your bite. Well, Luke,
I'm on mute,
there you go.
but I'm also Luke. I'm playing Ziggy, the Changeling Bard Wizard multiclass, who's also level 12. I'm also, I think, covering like Ruin if we get into combat, who's also level 12,
Oh,
sometimes a Dragonborn, sometimes a fairy. I'm also eating waffles.
nice.
Nothing to do with the game, but you know, that's what I'm doing.
11 will
It is
be
now.
Eleven will
Yeah.
be yellows. Yeah. Amazing. Thank you very much, guys. I think that's everyone, right? I'll start with this one. Yep. Thank you for introducing yourselves and your characters. Why don't we, as we have a guest star, I don't know, we keep doing this when it's Andy's turn to roll the group
I hadn't
inspiration.
even realized you mentioned it.
Yeah, but
Go, Ross,
will
go.
you guys be okay if our guest star
Yes.
rolls? Yeah, let's
Of
do it.
course.
What is that I'm rolling?
D6,
D6
please.
for the inspiration.
If you roll a one, we will take the two. As that's the lowest group
Oh, fine.
Never
inspirations.
mind.
Ooh, nice. Amazing. So you got five. Well done. Yay.
Five
Yep.
group inspirations.
That's awesome.
Indeed.
Okay, very good.
Do
Cool,
these
cool.
expire at the end of the session, do they?
Yep.
That's
Ooh,
fantastic.
best get cracking.
Thank you, thank you. Just last, as we are, as always, you will see our links to our YouTube channel on Twitch, in our YouTube and Twitch respectively, where you will find all our previous episodes. We have a Rollers of Fate D&D Gmail that you can contact us if you want. Content warning, beware, we have a Twitch at Fate D&D. And yeah, give us a follow. Thanks to everyone, Darren Curtis, Tessa Presents, and James Webster. And yep, amazing. Cool. And with all that said, thanks to my amazing players for playing with me this evening. And to everyone who is joining us from their homes, please make yourself comfortable, grab a nice drink. And as the parrots scream, let's see what mystery shall be revealed today. Yay! Cool. Previously on the sealed pages of Verglas, following a few days of downtime in which an act that changed some forever was committed, the Caravan of Chaos awoke to their scaliest member not getting up. Yet he was also rigid. Jokes aside, their newly changed to Dragonborn friend was dead, and his soul unwilling to return until the pact was fully sealed. After conversing with Archmage Rillia, The group reluctantly agreed to undertake the Harper's mission to travel to a custom-made demiplane inside a book to purify Aran Quill, an agent who remains corrupted by an evil tome no longer in his possession. In order to free Quill, he must be stopped by a unique magical dagger already given to the Cox. Once inside Wisteria Vale, this demiplane, our heroes experience unusual space, weather and reality abnormalities as they converse with some of the weird constructed villagers, finding out that there is a beholder who has become Quill's best friend. A ball to introduce the creature to the villagers is taking place tonight, and of course the Cox's sweet appeal got them invites. Finally, as the caravan explored Quill's mansion through Thorlo and Rippy Chip's eyes, soon it was clear that there is more than anticipated, as the silent owl was obliterated and the brave rat sucked into a painting, ending the mind link. Oof, okay. And this is where our story continues tonight. You all find yourselves in this warping demiplane, the sunny skies are now bright green with yellow swirls that randomly appear and disappear after a few seconds. Our frame moves closer towards the garden of Quill's opulent manor, where, amidst the pine trees, you all remain hidden, yet unaware, not alone. From the distance, another creature watches the watchers. And we'll start with you, Flair. As requested by the Caravan of Chaos by ascending yesterday, specifically Bruce sent a message to Bookworm asking for aid in order not to break their stealth, as you have been watching them hidden away. You've been a few minutes they are waiting. After looking for them for an hour around town since you arrived to this demiplane, from Candlekeep, teleported through that book, you think now it could be a good opportunity perhaps to approach them, as they have seems to have finished looking through their beastie's eyes. The reason you also know you are who you are, I'm not going to say that part, but you know what you know about them. You know quite a bit about them, and you even have news for them as well. As news have come on the grapevine that the Scales have potentially made another attack in this town. You know all the details. Once you want to explore it, we will go through it. But what's eventually happened is that after a dragon burned a church, everyone who was on that church turned into zombies. Those zombies attacked the villagers, and the whole town was completely destroyed by zombies, who the majority of them managed to escape and went into the forest. The paladins of Fort Morning Lord, including Hope and obviously Morning Glory, and all the other paladins, managed to kill a lot of them, but it's been like zombie attacks in all the nearby villages, and it's been really, really taxing. There is no mention that the Scales have claimed the terrorist faith attack. That's how it's seen at the moment, but everyone thinks that being a dragon is very likely that it's the Scales who did it. And that's what you know, and you want to tell them that info. You are here because ascending was received, and you were asked to come and help them, as that sending, that was the information on the sending. I'll leave it to you, Flair.
Okay.
If you have any extra questions or anything, you can always ask whenever you want.
Absolutely. Okay. I would say just let me try something here. I'm going to just roll something. Okay, that's pretty good. So as stealthily as he can, moving quite slowly so as not to give away any position, he comes round the side of the group so as not to startle them. He's remaining hidden from in front, away from the mansion, but not directly trying to remain hidden from the group. And he'll come along he'll come along parallel to them, maintaining distance from the mansion.
As he does so
with his hands visible.
As you start moving, the weather helps. From this yellow and green sky that has no clouds, rain starts pouring down. This yellow and green rain, it doesn't make any sense. There is no clouds on the sky, but it is raining, and that's giving you even extra advantage to be quiet and stealthy as you make your way. But you, please, great, keep going.
As he comes a bit closer, he moves, moving past trees, and if you give me some rope here, there's maybe some light coming off of the gardens or coming from the mansion. You can kind of see the figure coming towards you. He's just shy of 6 feet tall, so not very tall for this group. Wide-shouldered, short-cropped, kind of dirty red hair, and what would normally look like long white sideburns, but they're almost widened into a beard, and then they kind of fade in and out. It almost looks stripy, considering how dark his skin is underneath. Slightly pointed ears with tufts of hair on the end of them, and sharp cheekbones, and slightly pronounced teeth, incisors. There's a few fine scars places that you might see later when he's closer, but he's wearing a long floor-length black jacket over some very simple armor. Nothing in his hands, but clearly weapon strapped to his back. He's walking, looking at the mansion towards you. You can't do this alone, then.
Oh, we see him. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. I'll be like, oh, hello?
As the rain starts as well, where you are.
Mm-hmm.
Are you real?
Some interesting question. Someone contacted Bookworm.
Can I do just a look around us to see if I see anybody else besides just him?
Yeah. As you look around, you don't see anyone else beside you.
Okay.
So make sure I get this
only
right.
Only me.
So, mm-hmm. Bruce, absolutely out of game, said to Bookworm, hey, do you reckon you could have someone just maybe trail after us in case there's a problem?
Yeah. But okay, you don't have a memory of that. That didn't happen to you. Oh. That's what happened to him. Bookworm,
right, just wanted to clarify.
Bookworm got a sending from you asking for help, but you didn't do it.
Right.
But okay, it was then 100% you. There was, because on a sending, you know who sent it. It can't go, there is no way to kind of do that, supposedly, out of game completely.
You were not expecting me.
No.
We really weren't expecting anyone. Who are you?
My name is Flair. Bookworm sent me. One of you asked him to.
Bruce looks, we look around at each other. Did you?
No, I didn't. Did you?
Do I look stupid? Well, Despite the dress, Errol.
Who did Bookworm say sent you, basically, or asked for you? Did Bookworm say, hey, go to X person?
He said a group of mercenaries, the caravan he works with, and then he said something about Moonbear.
What?
No, it's just like a burst.
I look at everyone else.
Well, that's you, then.
I didn't conduct any sending. I don't know the spell for that. I don't have anything that could do that with. Oh dear, what's going on?
Okay. Well, don't love this. Don't love being in a demiplane for no reason. I've got better things to
do. Oh, so you know the situation.
Well, I've got better things to do. I could be fighting the zombies the scales have been creating all over the place. This is starting to look like a waste of time.
What?
The what?
The what?
The what?
What did you just say?
How long have you been? There has been a new wave of problems.
We've been We've been dragon
attack.
Just quickly, without me interrupting, just to give you more info, Flair, the sending came yesterday. You guys have been here a few hours. It's not really, doesn't make sense. So you don't, as far as you know, in your world, they've been inside this demiplane for more than 24 hours already.
So they feel it's been a few hours, but it has been 24 in the
At this point, okay. You still don't know that, though, but just to put it out there.
Okay.
We've been we've been gone for 2 minutes, and you're telling me a church has been destroyed, a dragon attacked, and the apocalypse has begun.
Well, maybe not that last one, but time does distort itself sometimes when you're going into different planes.
We better be getting paid travel.
We better be quick then. If time's moving more slowly here, and it's going fast out there.
Right.
Agreed.
Well.
Sorry.
I just need to ask then. What are we doing? Are we waiting for this party, or are we breaking in? We've got a rat to fight.
Considering the urgency, we might have to break in. Flair, why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself then, if you're here?
We're invited, but to be honest,
my time is best spent hunting the scales, is what you need to know about me. This is a courtesy to be here. If you don't want me here, and I don't know how to leave until the job is done, so I think we need to get the job done.
We need to get the job done. So, are we gatekeeping? Are we doing the party, or are we just breaking in?
I'm better at breaking in than partying, but...
Just hear me out. We do have an invitation. It'll only be a few more hours, and then we'll get in. It would save us breaking in, which could lead to all kinds of problems. I personally think... Damn it. I suppose a vote might be in order then.
The amount of time between now and the party, is that how long you feel like you have been here already?
I would like to think I'd be able to know with my wrist banner, but that's up to you, Cisco, if that's how that works.
Sorry,
like to think that with Errol being a traveler of the plains, this is what he does. His wrist banner would be able to at least give him an idea of how long he's been in here to basically confirm, we've been here 3 hours
I love that, a day or two. Make which skill? Arcana, I guess, right? That's what we've been using for your wrist banner.
I mean, you could either do Arcana or Nature, up to you.
Sure. I like those. Mm-hmm. Even Survival, want. Just you, though.
I think we arrive in the morning, it's early afternoon now, is that correct?
Yeah, out of game, yeah.
Okay.
Like
so we know how long it
is going to be. That's a low roll. That's just going to be a 15.
Does anyone want to help him in any way?
Not really. I do want to do something though while he's doing that.
Sure.
I'm going to say.
You said guidance, Bruce, right?
Sure.
Okay.
So a D4. Okay.
Yeah. Yes, I definitely said that.
Luke? Oh, really? I thought you said guidance while Luke was talking. I actually thought that.
Oh, yeah, of course I did.
Yeah, but Luke,
Yes, so while Errol is doing whatever he's doing, I'm going to take Bruce away for a minute and cast Gift of Alacrity.
Ooh.
So for the next 8 hours, you have a D8 added to your initiative. I give it to Yaru, but he isn't fucking here.
I mean, here's
a curveball.
Yeah.
Here's a curveball, and I'm sorry if the DM takes advantage of this. Is that 8 hours real time, or is it 8 hours in here?
It's 8 hours in here, I'm guessing.
Damn it.
let's do it. Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah. But it's hours on the whatever time you are running, you know? So.
Yeah. So you have. A D8 added to your initiative. Could be fun.
I'll make a wee note of that then.
Could be fun.
Anyway. Bruce, hold on a second till we know if we're going in now or if we're going in later.
It's 8 hours.
Anyway, so I got a 16.
It's 8 hours.
Hmm.
Yeah. Is that Mimosis Go? 16,
yeah, with a 16, you gathered. You have been in this place for around 24 hours, roughly. Let's say. Sorry, let me just check my notes quickly because 16 is enough, actually. So we are playing with your planar ability. So you will figure out that for. So you've been here. Works time difference is around for every hour is around 4 hours on the outside world, roughly.
Okay, so I'll just say it seems like every hour we spend here is about 4 hours, so it's about 4 hours faster outside in the outside of this plane compared to in here. So whatever amount of hours we spend,
less time than normal to solve this problem. So I'll save my life story and what I'm doing here for maybe a time where it's not going to cost us 6 hours to explain. Why don't we get the job? We get the job done. You're going to want me here for this.
That may be good. Are you good with a sword? Good with a bow? Good with spells?
Saying that he'll unsheath the sword he has, which is a very long, thin, dark blade. With kind of with a few teeth at the end that he's clearly rewrapped at the bottom. I'm good with whatever I take off the scales I kill, like this one.
Okay. Right,
you keep mentioning the scales, but I guess we'll talk about that later. I would prefer not to fight, so I guess we'll make this work for now.
Right. So,
plus the fact is, you did come to us without your weapon drawn, so that counts for something. Right. I'm even more of a proponent for breaking in, personally, given our time differential, but again, I'm not much of a party person.
Brucey boy?
Tell me, Flair, is it particularly dire out in the material plane, or is it in hand?
The paladins have organized nearby, and they've hunted most of these creatures into the woods from the point of the dragon attack, where everybody was turned. But it is not good,
right,
and certainly anybody in the certainly other villages in the way are not doing very well.
Is it under control, though?
It will be under control once I rejoin the fray, I would say.
So that's thinking highly of yourself?
I think I'm with Errol then, changing my mind about waiting until tonight.
Ziggy?
I'm ready to, I guess, rock and roll, because I want to get out of this disguise and this cup size.
That's right, you still look like a captain right now, don't you?
Yeah, and with saying that, I unshift into maybe just a random half elf.
Yeah. And still in a dress.
Yeah, it was a beautiful half elf girl, right? If I remember correctly.
I think I was just like some blonde, but now I'm just.
You were Kate Upton, come on.
I was Kate Upton, and then I'm just going to shift into my regular redhead half elf man. I'm still in the dress, though. I won't change.
Right, so. I'm assuming we could see the place from where we're at, maybe?
You are hidden beneath the canopy, kind of like in a garden, like it's a huge garden. And the garden itself is very overgrown, so it's really helping you, and from there you can see the mansion,
Gotcha.
Right. Well, I've got an idea, and Rune will also say, I also have an idea. And me and Rune both take out our chimes of openings and say, We can get in.
Yeah, well, also, just to make it easier on us, and then as everybody is around Errol will take out this leaf ash, he'll just sprinkle it up in the air, and he's going to cast Pass Without a Trace.
Ooh,
that's a plus 10, right?
Yep,
yes, sir.
Plus 10 stealth.
And
then he'll say,
that
that'll make it easier. I mean, just everybody's just going to keep it in mind.
Yeah. So, So doing that, I'll have casted Gift of Alacrity to Bruce. And, oh, Claire, quick question. Do you know what a beholder is?
Two of us do.
Yeah.
13. Heard of one, never seen one.
Actually, I think that might be more. 1 second. Give me 1 second. Arcana. So, yeah. Do an Arcana.
Arcana, that would
modifier.
Be it.
Be a
that would be another plus another 4 then.
Okay, so you know, yeah, you know, beholders are otherworldly creatures. You've heard roughly what they do. They are like enslaving slavers, completely crazy tyrants, normally evil by nature, but there is exceptions, I guess. Not that anyone knows any so far, but I'm sure there is somewhere. And they are very delusional creatures. They have a very strong beliefs. They are lawful, so whatever they believe at the time, they're gonna roll with that, and that's what they're gonna do. They are not easily change their mind. They are very stubborn in general. And deadly as well.
Knowing all that, Flair will go, you have flying eyeball.
Okay, well, just when it starts choking you, just remember I'll be like hidden behind you, and with that I shrink down to the size of a gnome.
Right, well, if we're all done here, let's see if we can see if maybe up the side somewhere. It's a pretty big location, but the bigger it is, that means there's more gaps to get in. Hopefully.
Let's have a quick scout, eh?
Before we go, Bruce will walk up to Flair. Talking about scales all the time. He'll reach out his hand and say, any of the scales, I consider an ally. And maybe it is a vested interest to get out here, but thank you for helping us.
Sure, we'll all be fine now.
You shake his hand, he's holding his hand out.
Yeah, he will look at you a lot. I suppose you're quite tall compared to him. He'll look at you, kind of.
He's looking at you very sincerely.
And he'll shake your hand. But it's more, he's still kind of looking over your shoulder at where we're going. Mm-hmm. Or around you, I guess, at where we're going.
Yeah, okay. Righto. Let's get a move on. By the way, listen, everyone, are we going in together? I'm assuming we're going together.
Because of the spell.
Yeah, the spell won't work unless we're all together, or at least close by, right?
If I remember correctly, as a player, that's feet. How the spell works, is that we have to be within 30 feet of each other.
I mean, we can break in easily. I'm sure about it.
So, stab the host, get the painting, run. Right.
Yes.
Bruce, it's you that has the dagger?
Yes, I do. I do now.
Yes.
Oh, he'll ask Geralt, we're both quite mobile, but you can teleport. Do you want it? If that beholder's there, it might screw with your magic, though.
Yeah, I think it'll be fine, even with that, so I think that's a better idea if I go out.
I can move it around between us if needs be.
Do you need to hold it, then?
No, I don't need to.
Okay, Errol, keep the dagger just now.
Alright, so adding it to my inventory, is it like a special dagger? What's it called? Or is it just, should I just add dagger and then just...
Yeah, you can just say black crystal dagger. I think that was the material that was made of for now. Let's call it a purifying crystal dagger. Because he actually purifies.
I'm just trying to think of like...
If someone is cursed or mind control or all those things.
The pure shank.
I love it.
Is that what it's called on D&D Beyond?
There is
of course,
no D&D
it's not
Beyond.
Called the pure shank.
It's just for this.
I'll just keep it in mind for...
Ensuring that he's standing quite close to Errol, Flair is going to walk a couple of steps in front of everybody else.
Bruce will give one of his displacement whiskers to Ziggy. Say, Ziggy, break that. It makes you harder to hit.
But how long?
For a minute or until you're hit.
I'll I'll keep it in mind, but I should be okay. I've got these Archmage robes pack a punch.
I agree, but you get your shit rocked quite a lot.
I know.
So
I think
he's
it's
giving
the
you
company I keep.
Quite possibly, he gives you one of the displacement whiskers. I still have one left. Basically, you get the blur effect.
Yeah.
So, in relation to the map, I'm just trying to figure out where we're at. Then we can just start proceeding down
where we think the painting
was.
So you will be here at the bone, here on that tree. Sorry, on that single pine, left out pine. Poor thing. Yeah, there. So you're kind of hidden by there. There is more vegetation and stuff all around you, overgrown. And the manor is here, is that square where Flair is.
Oh, okay.
That's the manor. So we are where, sir?
Uh-huh, yeah.
Top of the map.
But I will, once you get closer, because there is not an outside of the manor on the map as such. Let me just make sure, otherwise it might be easier. Yeah, there is not really an outside, so you'll have to decide verbally first where to go through, and then once you do that, then we
can... I would like to think that we would know which building the painting that Ribichi fell into was, and so that's the one that Harold will go towards. Because we had Ribichi from the outside and Bruce was watching, so...
I think the building we're next to is the manor.
Yeah.
So the thing you need to do, I need Bruce to make a survival check to determine how much he remembers of the actual physicality of the house. Even if it's been only a few minutes, you are looking from Rippy Chip's eyes.
No,
that
that's absolutely fine.
Yeah.
I'll give myself guidance and we'll get Mark back on because he's just joined the chat.
Oh, really? Oh, okay.
Hey,
okay.
Cool. He just got in.
Hello.
All right, perfect. So once he's got his camera in, hey, Mark, you got your camera on? Let me just throw you out.
Yeah.
Give me a few minutes. I'm currently
All right. So you give us a shout when you're ready. A minute.
Yeah. Don't forget, you still have inspiration if you want to re-roll it, like the group inspiration, or if you just want to save
those. I got a 15, so I reckon that's pretty solid.
I can give you a bardic.
Yeah, save your resources. I've got a 15. I think a 15 is pretty strong.
All
right. You believe to be what you believe is right. Once more, Mr. Andrew. Sure.
You're forgetting that we're in Mo and Cisco's game, Andy. That's
I
why.
Am going to 15. Roll one of the group inspirations then, I guess.
No. I mean, I said you believe right. You are good. You are fine.
As we're sneaking forward, Flair is going to reach around the back and unhook a helm that he has there, and he'll slip on the helm of dread, which comes down. It's kind of what is one of those kind of cut out eyes, kind of like an old Trojan one with two horns that come around the front. His face virtually disappears in darkness when he's got it on, and wisps of smoke come out from the corners of the red eyes as he's moving now.
Oh, nice.
The Blackbeard there as well.
Yeah, I'll whisper to Bruce, this guy's fucking intense.
He is a bit, isn't he? Look at that helmet. It's dreadful.
Let's not down his bad side.
Right, so I got my 15.
Alright.
Am I gonna regret not re-rolling this thing?
Well, with a 15, you barely remember. You are a bit confused, though, but you roughly know 100% is in the ground floor. That's something you know. You also know that there is another room right next adjacent to the place where he is. And you know it's very close from the main door as well. So that's quite
what's
a few
the main clues. Door, opposite.
Yeah. So okay, I will actually give you now the map, but you won't be able to see anything anywhere on it, unfortunately. But let's change it here.
Boo this man.
But actually, knowing that, there is all of you can make. Let's do a stealth check. Let's do perception checks if you wanna go around the property and figure out what could be the best place. You will have advantage, Siggy, because you already seen this through Thurla's eyes as well.
Perception or stealth?
I was also going to ask the order. Yeah. Do we do
Let's do perception and do stealth. Do the both rolls, you know, bam bam.
Bam.
wounded thing.
Oh, I have rolled
shit. Don't remember to, or don't forget to add 10 to your guys' stealth rolls just in case.
Oh, yeah.
I have rolled shit. On perception. And,
because, is this only sound based? Because I was just asking if I get advantage because of my boots.
You actually will, because the rain as well, you got an extra +3 to all your rolls because the rain is making noise around you, so it's helping you even more as well.
Wow. Ziggy. Flair's stealth is 37.
Fucking hell! How do you even do that?
Yeah, 35.
Ziggy, take a guidance for stealth from me.
Yeah. I haven't rolled stealth yet.
Yeah,
no, that's my perception.
Oh, was it? Never mind then.
I'm rolling stealth for everybody now.
Nice.
So Yagu has a stealth of, he also has it, so 27. And 33 for Zig for Ruin.
Oh wow!
And, 4 for me.
So okay. Plus 10, so 24. So nobody got below a 20, basically.
Okay, so you are fine. Yeah. You are super stealthy. Yep. With your perception checks, once more you feel watched. It's something you've been feeling all the way since you came to this place, and now more than ever, you notice. Hidden among the trees, there seems to be some unusual looking birds. Let me see what your rolls are, your perceptions.
Ziggy, I got a natural 20.
Yeah, yeah. Ziggy, 12. So he's, who else? Let's see here.
Flair, 27.
Amazing. Yeah,
there's 27, but a nat 20.
Yeah, okay.
And then.
So let's say at this point, Ziggy is a bit distracting. You kind of look at this. Kind of this tree, and you hear bear sounds, and you think of your owl, even though it's your familiar. It's just like the first time it dies, it's a bit weird. You're like, oh shit, you know, kind of thing, I guess. and you manage to not to see that on the trees, looking right at you, you see these weird looking birds that look like a mix between all different birds together, like it's got parrot colors, physicality of a tiny sparrow, the beak of a kind of like a hummingbird. So it's just wrong, you know, it's just a wrong creatures, you know, they don't look, and they're kind of dripping, like kind of like almost like the physicality is kind of dissolving and mounting themselves. They look at you. And as they notice you're looking, they kind of fly away.
Ziggy?
Yes?
Because I know last time we were thinking about this, you rolled a natural 20 on your knowledge of beholders. And they have spies.
Well, I mean, they usually don't work with other pit creatures. They don't like the company.
You will know that they don't work with other creatures, Ziggy, but they enslave other creatures to do their will. So it's not like they will be like, oh yeah, nice bird, help me. It'll be like, you do this or you die kind of thing, and they will do it. They're bullies, you know.
It could be a very codependent creature, maybe, or maybe a threatened creature.
Codependent, is that what we're calling slavery now?
Anyway, regardless of the bird's conditions, we do have to keep that in mind. Like I said, we'll still go in. If they can't see us inside, then the worst that we'll do is just, he'll just be aware that we're in here. But that might happen anyway, regardless of the situation, so.
Try our best and presume the worst, right?
Okay.
So, do we find a good way to get in?
Yeah, more things with your perception check. I will say that is enough, even for you, Ziggy, because, with a 12 is kind of like enough for you to kind of see what you need to see. You see now that all the windows that were before not really cared for, they seem to be all locked and shut, you know, like the curtain, the blinds have been down, you know, that they had these kind of blinds that roll down, and all the blinds have been shut where before there was open windows. Looking at the kind of like, obviously you don't really go through the main door, but it seems to be like the place is in high alert. You could figure that out there, all of you. There is breakable windows, there is a back door in the kitchen as well that you spotted before as well.
Maybe the back door through the kitchen, maybe the safest way. but it seems the place is on high alert.
I would like to put my ear to the back door, and I want to see if I could hear how many people are in the adjacent room, and I guess whether there's any background conversation. Not so much what they're saying, but just whether there's a lot of people talking in that room.
Yeah, I love that. So you, I think Mark is ready, is it?
I think he's still...
Okay, no worries. Yeah, it's just a camera change, I don't know, on his own.
But I'm let out.
No worries, sir. Cool. So with that, Errol, make a perception check. We'll roll in your previous stealth. I don't want to be asking you for stealths every 5 minutes.
Okay. Perception. Mm-hmm. Normal...
Will be based on sound. I don't know.
Not for the perception checks. Only for the stealth checks. 22.
With a 22, you hear bubbling. You hear chopping. You hear potentially, based on your perception, maybe two people very quiet, or one person. Yeah, there is someone there cooking. The sound of the one person doesn't match how many things have been cooked. Let's put it along. But you detect probably, you think probably one person or a few very quiet ones.
That's it. So Errol, it's not a thunderstorm, so he can't time it with the lightning. So Errol is just gonna really quickly just peek through the door, so like open it a crack, and then just look through the eye and try.
The door is locked.
Prefer to try to avoid making sense.
Yeah, the door is locked.
Okay, never mind. And we know
Flair's gonna put a hand on Errol's shoulder before he starts doing anything. We are clearly expected, should we really be going through something. They know opens and closes. Why not go through one of the locked windows or something they think we would not?
Yeah.
Only because of the sound of if we break a window.
There are
the only reason I'm considering the door.
Two members of this party have already waved around chimes of opening.
But I'm pretty sure those chimes make sounds to open something, so...
Yeah, just to clarify, you have also shutters, you know? So you will have to kind of either unlock the shutters, that is going to be hard to do from the outside, or you will have to break in through the door, unlock the door, but she's gonna be there, or they are gonna be there, or whoever is there.
I didn't realize the shutters part, so I'm like, oh, okay, that's gonna be a bit too much of a hassle. Do I see any upper windows or anything like that? It might be easier going up and then
down.
You
see other upper windows also shut and barred. Well, no, they're not barred, they're just kind of like closed. Yeah.
How did Thurlow and Reepicheep get in then if they're all shut?
They were open before.
I think there was an open window.
Yeah,
all of them were open before.
Actually.
Oh dear.
Like they were not expecting anyone.
Errol, I think he has a point. This place is on high alert ever since we sent Reepicheep and Thurlow in. This beholder at least knows we're coming.
Does it not seem to imply we should go in with a crowd later at the party? We can walk in the front door then. We need not be bottlenecked through the only thing that opens, where there is undoubtedly trouble waiting for us.
The thing is, though, if we come in with a crowd, there's more chances of chaos happening because there's more people. Plus, who knows how long Reepicheep can last in the painting.
Oh, Reepicheep will be fine. We just need to get him out, that's all.
Then I vote for the chaos option, because that's usually where we are shining.
Right, it is. There'll be at least another half a day, or another day will pass outside of here while we're waiting, but if the group thinks we should do that instead back to our original plan, then fine.
Better late than dead.
Good point. Ziggy?
Fine, I guess. The one time I'm ready for guns blazing.
I mean, there's still going to be guns blazing, there's just going to be more people when we eventually do everything.
Exactly, the more the merrier, right? Ziggy?
Death the merrier is the situation here, Yagyu.
You said that once again as well.
They're constructs though, aren't they?
Yes, they seem very curious in my walk through time.
Right, well, let's...
Very well, we can head back, but in the meantime, at least we're taking a look around to get a better lay of the land, so it hasn't been totally wasted.
And we do know that they are at least probably expecting us. Mm.
Some of you seem dressed for a party already. Is this something perhaps I am missing?
Oh, I need to get changed.
We can...
No, you stay!
We can get you party clothes, and I'll pull out just the glamoured armour, or just maybe just some general party clothes I already have in my like bag of holding. These take your fancy? Also, I pull out the disguise kit.
Disguise kit I can do, but I'm not trying to look like somebody else. I'm just trying not to look like I'm trying to sneak into the house. I guess be less conspicuous by looking conspicuous.
Well, this will...
louder clothes.
He'll chuck you the glamoured studded leather. I don't know whether you need that, but it's magical armour and it just disguises any clothing. Mm-hmm. I expect that back, though.
Thank you, I shall return it.
Yes, you better.
Right, are we changing our minds again?
I don't know.
I like it. Well, that's annoying, but oh well. Let's get a better look at the lay of the land before we leave, then.
Right, Sisko, I think we are going to revert back to our original plan of going with the party. And are we still going to go with the whole schmooze, the hosts, and then our little group to go get Reba Cheap, or are we sticking together?
I guess we're going with the schmooze of the host, because by the time the time passes, pass without a trace is already done. So, because we're going to need to wait longer than an hour in here to get to the party.
Yeah, I just our original plan was that Ruin and Ziggy during the party will chat to the hosts, while three of us will split off during the party to then go and get Reaper Cheap.
Yep.
Are we doing that, or are we just sticking together?
We're doing that.
Yeah, and keep the party going.
Right, grand. Okay.
This is glamoured, you say?
Yes, glamoured studded leather.
Perhaps I can look like one of the staff if we... I'm escorting you somewhere if we become stuck.
As you say that, you like put on like a waiter's get up, or it just appears on you.
Yeah. As we're walking back to sort of wait for our time here, Bruce will turn to Flares. Is it you're asking us a question about who sent us? Did I hear that right earlier?
I have been told. Yes, well, that was to do with the birds. We seem to be assuming they're of the beholder, but. Yes, oddly colored birds, no? Things that conspicuous. I spend much of my time hunting mages amongst the scales. They are arrogant people. When they create things, they can't help but put little of themselves in there. So I wondered if you remembered who sent you. Were they that colorful as the birds were? Are you being watched to make sure you're completing your mission correctly?
A member of the Harpers sent us to rescue one of their own who'd come afoul of an archmage. A corrupted one.
Okay. A mage themselves who sent you?
Yeah, I believe so. A wizard.
Dressed how?
You can all make arcana checks if you want, actually. So, just to clarify and see what your role with this, and then you might deduct something. But she was dressed
God,
as...
God, how am I rolling so shit?
Oh, guys.
Should I still roll for Yagu?
Once again, Choku. Carry in intelligence.
I have a fucking 12 in intelligence.
She was dressing white and green robes, very flowy, with golden in kind of like on the rim, some kind of inlay on it. Nothing really recognizable to any of you. Just seems to like a nice color coordinated
style. Clearly a wizard, though.
Definitely a wizard. I think she told you herself at some point. Yeah. Say that she did.
And this was not the color of the plumage of the birds, for instance.
No.
Okay.
However, only you, Yagu, will figure out that the birds you saw, as you know quite a lot on nature, being on your lake for so long, kind of these creatures that you saw, and you as well, Flair, 17. That's cool too. These creatures were otherworldly. They were not from this world. Let's put it like that. Those little birds.
Okay, so in the absence,
it's not like a recognizing. You don't recognize anything. They look like, if someone who is not sure how lots of birds look like would just say they look like this, some kind of like a kid would put together a drawing of birds, their interpretation of what a bird would look like.
The birds stood out, and if they were not sent here from another world, by who sent you? I submit they must be the beholders then.
Agreed.
Alright.
Actually, I'm wondering if even us going disguised will work, because if they are the beholder, won't it just tell him how we look, for instance?
I mean,
I think we should assume the best, prepare for the worst.
Right.
So do what we can.
The beauty of a changeling, though, their arrows is that a blonde may enter, but a brunette may leave.
Good,
that sounded a lot better in my head.
Fair point, I suppose.
Undoubtedly.
Either way.
The rain stops.
Hey, we don't judge, Shiggy.
Yeah. Well,
I'll make my head gray. To make our own preparations, and could we take a short rest in that case?
Oh yeah, definitely.
If we're just gonna
you
be waiting
could
for the
do that.
Anyway.
Would you like to go to the Blossom's Rest? Would you like to hang around the marketplace? Would you like to go into the forest that you haven't really been yet? That it could be a good place to hide and be out of sight. Up to you.
From which direction do we imagine the party goers will come?
Know they're coming from there. So you could go into this forest up here, by example. That will give you an easy way. You could go and hang out in the inn. You could go, yeah. Because the place itself is not that big, you know, so it feels like there is people around as well everywhere all the time, you know.
How did you come by your invitation?
Oh, we kind of talked to some of the locals. It was a very strange conversation.
Henrietta and Storm and Josephus Lovett were guests of theirs.
You needn't arrive together.
I mean, I suppose not. I assume we'd meet up with them and then kind of walk off once the party started getting lively.
Yes, but if you're invited as their guests, needn't you pass through the door together?
Yes, we should probably meet up with them then.
That sounds more like an alibi to me.
Fair.
So you have 2.5 hours to kill, roughly. Assuming you're meeting these people,
well,
and that will give you half an hour to walk with them and chat with them for a bit before you leave.
Right, well, if we do that, I'm gonna
so forest
do
market
an arcane recovery
or
and
before you take any rest. Where are you taking this rest? So you wanna go to the forest?
Oh, then we go to the
go
inn.
Inn. Or you wanna go
yeah,
to
just
the
go back to
the
inn.
It's probably the best.
Okay.
Go to the inn where it's dry.
Right, yeah, probably the inn.
The rain has stopped as well now, so there is no rain anymore.
Cool, cool. It might rain again.
Yeah. As you make your
the dread helm is off.
Through, then you see that the inn is fairly few people inside. As before, you kind of arrive the Blossom Rest tavern. The same male dwarf Uldrich and his wife kind of like greet you and stuff as you kind of enter. There's like a performance going on as well, and they ask you just given drinks and stuff, place your order, you don't need to pay. Doesn't seem to be a money concept in here, so everything is just given to you for free, kind of thing. And they don't even ask.
You would love it here.
Yeah. And you see that there is a few villagers sitting in all the tables and stuff. Let me retake your camera, Mark. I don't know why I moved earlier. So now that you're here, I can do that in the background. But yeah, you're in the inn. You can click the short rest button. And you have your drinks. Some food as well, if you want. You are offered food.
Ziggy's going to arcane recovery to get that spell slot back.
Oh, nice.
but you should still have about 7 hours of Gift of Alacrity, Andy.
Sure. There's nothing much else that I can do. I could maybe have a go at lifting the mighty dumbbell, but that might be about it.
I believe we already tried it for today.
Did we? It's been a while for me to remember.
I'm not sure if it's today. Did you try it today? I think when you were waiting, maybe, actually. I have some kind of memory of that.
Problem.
Make a fair roll.
I don't think
you
guys did,
someone.
But I could be wrong.
Yeah, and I don't know how much the time shenanigans will do this. I'm going to go high.
Hi.
Ooh, okay. So 19. Let's say that you are able to use it. Two people can try. Again, because
sure,
I think you have used it, but I've been very nice here.
I genuinely can't remember. And I never took a note. It's been three weeks.
It's
cool. Let's do it.
I can remember something about it.
Yeah, buddy.
Ooh. Okay, amazing. So tell me what you got. 1 second.
26.
Winter. Wow, okay. Definitely. So yeah, he's on, right?
Haha, uh-huh. Bruce gets even more swole.
Amazing.
Yeah. I cast prestidigitation on his suit as it kind of rips with him lifting the dumbbell.
He would have done it, but he's still wearing Aki's sleeveless coat, so that doesn't get ruined.
You get changed close to the time.
Space for the delts, you know, right?
Absolutely.
Well, you can't close it, it's too small. But you can still, like, wear it.
Okay, well, I guess we're just waiting for the party then. I mean, hopefully we keep the drinks flowing and just may cause a few distractions. May get into a bar fight. I say that, and then Ruin instantly tries to oppose it. But I'm not doing his voice, because I'm tired.
Yeah, if Ruin wants to get into a bar fight, there is enough people here to get into a bar fight if he wants.
I mean, it's not a matter of when, or will, it's more a matter of when.
If Ruin spends too much time talking to someone that's not us, he will end up picking a fight with them.
Yeah. Well, that's my plan. I'm sure Lucky will be fine with it. He's given me full range.
Sure.
Ruin, what are you doing?
Yeah. If he were to get into a fight with a face slap, it would probably be enough to kill this creature. So he can describe to us how he kills it if that's the intention. I don't know.
We'll see how the dice go.
Yeah, let's say that there is like a very
seeing this starting to kick off. Flair is starting to push his chair away from the table that they're all sitting at.
Yeah,
slowly
would be one of those
shimmying
situations
away from...
where maybe Dragonborn goes to the toilet, pushes the drink over table, the kind of passes dismissive, and the woman on the table that seems to be quite masculine, they are sitting with another masculine woman, both of them kind of like look quite angry and expect an apology. There is no apology given, and even though they are not drinking the drinks, because these creatures don't drink or eat, she still has a row and goes crazy.
I mentioned the party, by the way, like when we're in there.
Oh, okay. So
then
I live in the present.
Okay,
you meant now
as well.
No,
not sure.
No, like no my worries. Plan was to get into a bar fight as like a distraction
so
during
then,
the party.
A
sorry,
fight.
I should have made that clear.
Okay. All right. I'm sure there won't be any security at all.
A ballroom blitz.
Sounds like a great
you
idea.
You may say.
Yeah. Wonderful.
Sounds
shall
very,
we? Shall we get
very,
to?
Very
I want to try one thing before the short rest. I'm just curious what's going to happen. Joku will walk to the bar dude and he will cast Command, and he will command him to drop whatever he has in his hand.
Ooh, okay.
I'm curious what's going to happen.
Okay.
Is it a creature or no?
As you do, does it work on constructs?
No. It says a creature.
Yeah, constructs are creatures.
Creatures
are constructs. Yeah. It's humanoid and stuff like that. But constructs are creatures, right? Every creature is creatures, I think. Make a Make an Arcana check, I guess. That's the one for Construct normally. Let me just check here. Maybe. And tell me what you roll as well.
I rolled a 9.
Okay. Alright. Yeah, 9. I guess a 9 is not gonna be enough, but you think they are creatures, 100% sure. With a 9 you will know that, as you kind of try to figure out what these things are. And you cast Command. What is it? Wisdom save, I think?
Wisdom, yes.
That is... 12?
Nope, 17.
Okay, that second, he doesn't have anything on his hands, but what he does, you see he actually unscrew both of his hands and drops them on the floor. And at this point, you realize it's something like from Westlife, you know, like they actually made of wood inside, yeah, with a skin outer layer kind of thing. And he kind of stand there with no hands for the duration without even questioning it.
Do you need help to get them back on? Because I assume it would be a pain in the ass to do that without hands.
He looks towards you. He says, how long does the spell last, actually? One round, right? Yeah.
I think only one round.
Yeah.
Duration one round. Yep.
Yeah, he will just look at you and say, no worry, I'll just pick them up if that's okay with you. He kind of slowly looks at you, see, asking.
Yeah,
for
but
permission.
How are you going to pick them up? You have no hands. That's what I'm.
Oh, damn. Okay, could you help me as you actually force me to do that?
Yeah, that's what
understand.
I.
Oh, thank you. Okay, I thought you wanted to score me home. I thought you are such a nice gentleman, but I'm going to the party later, so I need to. I'm already dressed, he says. Thank you. And he puts his two stumps.
Could you maybe tell me what you are?
Oh, I'm a constructed commoner. My name is Delilah, she says.
And as a construct, do you have like a goal, or what is your purpose here?
Oh, to make Quill happy. All of us' purpose is to make him happy. We live to make sure he finds this place as comfortable as any other place could be. So we are alive, she says, convincingly.
Understood. And he will screw the hands on the robot lady, and he will go back to the group.
You're very nice. If there's anything I can do for you, let me know.
I will talk to you in a minute, probably, maybe, who knows. Otherwise, I will see you at the party.
Alright. And she kind of sips her drink, doesn't drink anything, and puts it back on water or whatever.
Okay, everyone, I might have discovered something super unethical we can do, but I'm still not sure because they are kind of constructs. So I'm not sure if we are allowed to abuse them or not. It's weird. I'm confused now.
What do you mean exactly? And did she just lose her hands?
Yeah, but okay, long story short, they are all wooden robot thingies, you know?
Yes.
And apparently their job is to make Quill happy.
Right.
Maybe we can use that in our advantage?
How would we do that?
Okay, this is my plan. From the beginning, I'm going to say I'm against my plan because, like I said, I'm still in a very unethical situation right now because I don't know if, you know, they have souls or not, these robot thingies.
A good way to start out a plan is by telling us how unlikely you want this plan to happen.
Well, this is my idea of a plan. I hope for you guys, you know, better plan somehow. But if we act like, yo, we are the, you know, people, we're here to make Quill as happy as possible. That's our job. We are in management, you know. You kind of work for us. If we do that to the robot thingies, that might, you know, put them on our side. We can use that.
Certainly, we could convince them of doing something distracting, which would make Quill happy. No.
Exactly. So, how do
they
we
flash
do that?
Mob. We leave the room.
Oh. Oh, I have an idea.
Thank you. Oh no.
No, this could be good. It's a party.
You usually say that. Last time you said that, you said you were like a...
Why don't we make it a proper celebration? We've still got time. We could stir something up, maybe?
You want to reverse a dance together?
No, I'm thinking...
Oh.
I'm thinking have a surprise maybe planned, or... I don't know. We may not have time for that. I'll think on it.
It was just a suggestion of something we could maybe use, so it's up to you guys.
I don't really have any... I'm not particularly good at infiltration, so I'm kind of along for the ride.
Well, as long as you focus on getting Repeat Sheep out, then...
I'm intending on just grabbing the painting and then just sticking it in the bag of holding, honestly.
That what is a Repeat Sheep?
The painting could be more than a painting. It could be...
Repeat Sheep is one of our allies.
But one of you was already captured.
Yes, he's quite small, so he's able to sneak in, and he got caught. He touched a painting and sucked him in.
It's a rat. I don't think we can consider him an ally.
You take that back right now.
Rats is.
Anyway, getting hit at least by painting is part of the deal, so we'll need to focus on that. Anything else beyond that, then we'll need to find where he's at, which is going to be the bigger problem. I would assume wherever he is, that beholder is going to be close to him. So there's another issue altogether.
We don't know, the beholder may end up in the party.
Well, if he's like any other wizard, I doubt he's just going to tell his main defense, yeah, feel free to socialize and be away from me. So wherever he is where that beholder is. Most likely.
Do we believe the beholder has... A holdover Quill.
I believe it's the other way around.
Seems to. From what we've gathered, he seemed to have turned up about 2 weeks ago in this reality's time frame, and ever since Quill's been infatuated.
Yeah, he's been kind of
to the point where he's not seen the guests.
Yeah.
The NPC, the sort of constructs around here aren't really coping with it well.
You mentioned
is this the angle that? Turtle friend speaks of, then, is this tension between the newcomer and those that were designed to keep him happy?
Potentially, that could be something.
Like, the Beholder and Quill are also friends, apparently. Apparently they are best friends. Are we sure the Beholder is an evil creature?
A Beholder would convince you of this.
Do we know why the Beholder is here in the first place?
We don't know why he's here.
No,
why is Quill here in the first place? What were we doing again?
Jesus, that is a Mark question, not a Yuri question. I have the notes.
He was cursed, right?
He was cursed by some kind of book that he doesn't have in his possession anymore. And then since then he turned evil. So then eventually, because they know
that he's possessed,
then they don't want to hurt him because it's not really his fault. And they put him in this place to rot until they find a cure, pretty much.
Also, when we're trying to think what beholders were, Ziggy rolled a natural 20 and Bruce rolled quite high, and I believe Ziggy realized they can dream themselves into places.
Yes.
They can dream up things and make them real. So he probably dreamed himself into his demiplane possibly by accident, possibly on purpose. We don't know.
I mean, if I'll sort of whisper this, if I can get a punishment off, this may solve all our problems. However, I'm highly unlikely on that front.
Well, if you were to banish the beholder, this would sever his hold over Quill, but Quill is still infected. Quill is still an evil mage who must be stabbed.
Yes.
Potentially.
Theoretically, we could end this very quickly. We just get close enough to go, Rillia says hello. Perhaps do it twice.
That would be ideal.
She did say it might take multiple, so...
You can always just go inside and then make a plan from the inside once we have more information about how this night might go.
Well,
let's just get in.
Yes, let's vamoose.
You can all make an insight check as well if you want, also to deduct one more kind of what Ross said before, like a point of view, like a angle. Yeah, that's the expression. The word.
I think that's the highest I've rolled all night.
Ooh. Got a 15.
Nice.
Roll.
It's guidance as well.
Insight. Nice.
21, 21, 25, and guidance. Yago 22.
Wow. 22.
Okay, amazing, everyone. Okay. We Herald 15. Yeah, Herald is too distracting trying to figure out the time and the demiplane and the whole situation that your rift panel keeps rotating and stuff like that. Everyone else kind of also realize something. Based on what is happening here, Quill must be aware that he's been put here by the Harpers and everything, so he must know the whole story. And you gather that you wouldn't want to be living here in this place. Maybe he doesn't know that the people are constructs, maybe he thinks he's in a little village, but he knows it's not his village, because his village was destroyed by the fire that he caused himself. So you know that it must be quite daunting for him to be in this place where he destroy everything influenced by darkness, and to be living here must be some kind of nightmare for him. So there might be another possibility that he might be willing to be stopped if that means that he's gonna go back home. However, you don't know how much he's possessed still or darkened, so yeah, might go not the way you want, but there could be an option there too.
Banishment.
That, what do you guys like to do? The time has passed.
I cannot perform this spell, but this requires him to resist. No.
Potentially. I mean, I have ways around it. It's just whether he can just decide not to. Sometimes it's they decide they can succeed. Legendary actions. Legendary resistances. But he takes out the Shards of Altair, and this can help us banish it. However, it's a bit weaker than my regular magic.
If we do things in a specific correct order and make his ability to resist such magic as weak as possible before you fire this crystal, perhaps this works.
Essentially.
Perhaps we do not have to fight Quill at all.
Let us hope not.
Around 6 o'clock arrives. You guys know at this point you should be heading towards the silk and souls, clothiers, tailors. But you said something, Mark, I completely interrupted you. Will you please
repeat? No, let's go to the party. That's
okay. Cool. So if everyone is cool with that, you meet with Henrietta and Josephus, and go with them together. They're kind of like looking sensational. They have this black, the woman has got this black huge dress, like with a nice shine, like all her hair is made up, beautiful makeup, same as him, also quite dressed up a little bit non-binary. He's got a bit unusual looking clothes and a mix of both genders, the same with her a little bit too, in bits. And you are being escorted by them. Oh, so how have you been finding the place? Joseph would ask you, are you enjoying your time here?
Of course, yes. Doing what we can, keeping busy, having some fun. It's a nice little town.
Oh, that's amazing. Oh, I see you have a friend. Have I met you before? He says. Do you, Fleck?
No, but, is what you're wearing, typical of the village, is this a local's style? Oh. Something that makes Quill happy?
No, this is more like us, really. I mean, we still, this is what me and my non-husband like. He kind of says, kind of sighs to that. We're gonna be like that.
And Flair will get the glamoured armor to look a bit more like what they're wearing, so he feels that he fits in a bit more and looks less like he's there to cause any trouble. He'll do his best to use it to hide the staff and sword strapped to his back as well. And he'll try and use his tail, for he has one of those, a cat-like tail, to kind of hold out parts of this fabric and make it move in a way that disguises that he has anything with him.
Amazing. As kind of thinking of that, is any of you have huge weapons that could potentially be quite obvious?
Probably the longbow, probably. Thinking about it,
we all have back to holding.
Where do I begin?
Yeah, so I like that. So I imagine just think of that, because you'll take an action to get weapons out, one at a time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I've got a short sword.
You could conceal simple weapons, let's say, as long as they are not like a lance or some shit like that, you know? If it's like a short sword, dagger,
yeah,
or kind of like a small...
Well, it's a silver short sword, so I can... Maybe I'll, while we're getting ready, I'll use my disguise kit and just be like, make it look more ceremonial, as in it's like a peace offering, or like, this is my party sword.
All right. I mean, if you want to try to do that for everyone, I will allow you to make some kind of check. And let's see if you want. And you could make everyone's weapons look like a ceremonial looking hidden weapons, like part of their outfit.
To give myself advantage, as like maybe a performance check, can I use my disguise paints, the magic ones?
Sure, yeah, I love that. I like where you're going.
Yeah,
You could actually apply a little bit of paints to some places. Yeah, amazing. Yeah, do that.
I was gonna say, Bruce would put all his weapons in the bag of holding if needs must, but he is gonna suggest to Ziggy, maybe you could tell them that this one, he points to Gutwrencher, that this is a symbol of leadership amongst Clan Elfbane, and I cannot be parted with it.
I'm sure we can do that. I'm sure that we can do that. But with a 32...
Yeah, amazing. You could definitely conceal the weapon, try to make it into a part of a costume. Like, if you're okay with that, Bruce, you could have like a really weird looking costume, maybe like some kind of black veil that comes from your weapon, like almost like concealing the half of you and the weapon. It could be kind of trendy in this forbidden place, I guess. Foreboding.
I mean, he's got his shoulder cape, but that could be like built into it or something.
Yeah, yeah, because Siggy's doing it, so yeah, definitely I'll love where this is going. So yeah, cool. Anyone else would like not to put their weapons on the back of holding?
Yeah, I will just, yeah.
I won't be.
Step of heating, I will just use it as a walking stick.
Yeah, perfect.
I'll do the same with my staff. The sword is a rapier, so I suspect I can hide that effectively.
Yeah, rapier you can hide. And what about Mr. U. Emmerfield? What will you like?
So the longbow and shield, I'm gonna have to put away in the bag of holding. There's no getting around that.
No, you could try. You could try to make it part of your costume. Like I'm imagining, kind of like it's gonna look super camp. You're gonna look like a drag queen show. But sure, you could try to wrap it with different things. And I don't know.
You've got that dagger from Errol.
That's what I was gonna say, is that I have other weapons, so that's why I don't mind putting those two away specifically. So
perfect.
If I put those two away, I would have a poison dagger and a short sword plus one, so I would have three weapons that I would need to conceal.
Yeah,
I don't know if that makes a difference, but basically two daggers and a short sword.
Ruin just kind of looks at you all and says, amateurs, and while holding out the Hundry, he just he just absorbs it into him and it just disappears. Fucking amateurs.
Amazing. And you all make your way on your fine outfits and stuff. What do you guys want to do? Do you want to still do a little break, or what do you guys want to do with that? Because this could be a good place before you enter.
Maybe a break would be good. Yeah.
Long enough to go for a pee. That's all
right. Yeah. Okay. So let's do that then. If everyone is cool with that, so we'll take a little break. We'll be back in a few minutes. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon as the guys are gonna enter the mansion. Cool. Bye. Thank you. Alrighty, and we are back. Thanks so much for holding on as we continue our craziness here. I'm so looking forward to this. Oh, wow. This is a dream come true. My second beholder, I think. Yep, okay, it's gonna be fun. Third? I don't know. Amazing. So let's see. I'm sure everything is gonna go really well, and yeah, it's gonna be a good, happy ending for everyone.
It'll be fine. It'll be fine, no problem.
Yeah. Cool, cool. So as you guys are escorted with these two people who you are on their guest list, I close the window of the names. No one cares. They kind of go first. They are greeted. You see that there is servants on the door, kind of smiling. You see the place itself as you are about to enter through the main door. You see that the place itself is beautifully decorated. There is garlands of wisteria. You see a few people in the middle of the room as you enter. You kind of go into this hall first. Bruce, that this is kind of one of these rooms here that you see. You see four rooms. You know that one of them is the one where Rippy Chip is in here. You also know, Ziggy, where the kitchen is. You all do. I will move you into the map. Just give me one quick second. As I describe, as you see, there is full of villagers dressed in beautiful outfits as well. It's around 30 of them, a few of them that you can see on this place. They seem to be going around. But you also notice that some of the doors seem to be closed, the majority of the doors, apart from the ones that you've been taking through. You are taken into a room that seems to be like a ballroom, kind of with a stage on the top. This room is a room you haven't seen before as well. You haven't been here yet. And you see, it's like a ballroom. You see on the door, there is this pair of beautifully decorative armors, metal armors, like knights, kind of like standing on the door, immobile. And as the door opens, you see a dazzling and a spacious room, polished walls, gleaming to the light of hanging lamps, shaped like celestial bodies. And you see on the ceiling paintings of constellations. Also on the east wall, you see a long stage with red velvet curtains closing a backstage area. There is a portrait of Quill posing on the chaise longhangs on the north wall. And there is also an image, you notice that the image is distorted as if someone has smeared paint on it and kind of like before it dried. The ballroom itself is two floors high. There is a 50-foot high ceiling with a balcony that you see from the very top, kind of there. And there is canapes being served and stuff. What would you like guys to do? Orchestra playing.
Sorry, did you say there was something weird about that painting?
Sure, as you get a little bit closer, you notice that the portrait of Quill seems to be a little bit distorted. Make up either investigation or perception check if you want, as you kind of approach it. Also, the rest of you, there is like some pleasant music being played, and no one seems to be giving you any attention at the moment.
This is a separate painting from the one Bruce knows Reaper Chief got sucked into, yeah?
Ah, yes.
Yeah.
The one you saw Reaper Chief is in some kind of a small lounge, kind of like a...
Let's yeah, that's kind of got a note of that, okay.
Oh, fuck. Can I use inspiration?
Yeah, go for it. Sure.
Yeah, cool. I may add...
You might not need it.
Well, it's an 8.
But I can tell you whatever it is that I see. Or it's up to you.
I'll re-roll it, that's fine.
We're running out of time. You say we got 4 after that.
18.
Okay.
Oh, you rolled an at 20. Never fucking mind.
That's why I said, yeah.
I didn't see.
It's fine, we got 4 left.
Okay.
Alright, amazing. As you kind of do that and have a look quickly, into the painting. Sorry, one second, because I lost the page. My apologies.
Not to further burden you. The music seems to have stopped as well.
I know. I was looking for the music, and then I lost the page. It's the two things. Let's put Psych on the organ. Whoops. I'm gonna drive you crazy for a little. You're gonna hate this.
That's fine. Just roll with this.
Okay.
The last time we had Flair, for my one shot, we had organ music in the background.
Yeah. Oh, really?
We're in a fun house, so.
Okay, as you kind of like look into the painting, it feels something weird. Like I mentioned, it's been smeared with some kind of paint, and as you look into it a little bit more, you see that the painting itself seems to be moving almost. There is features on the painting that seems to be a little bit etherealish. Also, with your perception checks Errol, Flair, and Ziggy, you also realize the two armors that were resting peacefully on the door are getting towards you. One of them is flickering the finger like that, saying no to you. Coming, walking in into the room, kind of pushing guests on the side.
Oh, sorry about that. we'll be on. And while we do that, I'll just kind of
arms crossed.
Yeah,
I'll just
scratch a little like copper wire down at the bottom of my hand as it rests down, and just do a little message to Errol and say something's up with that fucking painting.
I agree.
We need to try and get in there. Also, these armors. Dodgy. Maybe. Maybe the moose. Well, when you can.
Make a stealth check. As you cast the spell.
Stealth check.
Quietly.
Yep,
normally, I don't allow that, but there is a lot of people. It's a party going, so it's definitely not.
Well, also, like, nobody can hear the message anyway.
Yeah, no, it's just the fact of you seeing the casting. The armors are looking towards you. That's the two.
23.
Okay. With a 23, this, you think all is good, and you keep talking to the message. Sorry, keep going.
Yeah, so that's basically it. Just, there's something up with that thing.
I like the idea of keeping you without a map, so I'm gonna keep you without a map just for a little bit longer, just to piss you off.
Is that because you can't find the map?
No, I have it here ready.
No,
I have it here ready. It's just more for you to kind of create it more immersive, yeah. Because I think in the moment you have a map, everyone, including me, you start looking around and then you lose it a bit. So it's nicer to keep it more like this, so you don't know the structure.
Anyway, I think Ziggy's gonna try and mingle with some of the guests, and I think Rune's gonna attempt to do the same. But I guess like I'm gonna keep an eye on like maybe vantage points or just something. Well, keep an eye out for this beholder when it eventually turns up. But yeah, I may just kind of whisper to everybody else about that weird painting as well, and just say the armors don't like it.
Another strange painting. Interesting.
This one's.
Flair's going to ask one of the animated suits of armor where the bathrooms are.
You ask where the bathroom is. One of them kind of points on this direction. Let me actually find if there is a bathroom. It should be one. Normally, you know, this D&D world, people never go toilet somehow, and definitely these people don't. That's
yeah,
for sure.
We're not.
We don't play this game to go, oh, by the way, it's time for a bathroom break in game.
No.
Oh, you better have a shower now.
Of course,
come on.
No one does. I'm just saying. That's why there is no bedrooms.
You'll stealth for
oh, no, there is a
guest
bathroom.
You haven't washed
okay.
in a week.
No, I'm incorrect. Guest's bathroom. So they will. One of them kind of points down there, kind of into a direction, and you see that the direction is pointing is diagonally towards the stairs that go up, kind of outside of that room where you are. And you see then now that there's been kind of like a, one of those metal things that they put on the VIP parties that is like with a string in the middle, you know, and it's kind of blocking some parts of the house for you to kind of be guided through if you were to go to the bathroom.
If Flair moves in that direction, does he go on his own or does one of these things escort him?
They don't escort him. They stay there next to the painting, both of them.
Then he will walk quite slowly towards that, and whoever else he passes in that direction, he'll kind of make eye contact with them.
Is it in the same direction as the room that Ripichit's painting is in, Cisco?
You will go into the hall where Ripichit's room is, but Ripichit's room is on the ground floor where you are also.
Right, and so it's the same direction.
Yeah, it will be the same direction, right. But then you will have to go into the room and kind of like a sneak. Now there is not the two guards that were on the door, they are not there anymore. So far you've only seen these two.
Little Bruce will whisper to everyone else that Ripichit's painting is that way. I'm going to go over there now. Grab it.
Just in case.
You guys go there, I will see what the main thing is about.
Yep, so Bruce and Errol are going with Flair, I believe.
Okay, so let me make
and
a...
You said there's a stage in here.
Yeah, that's the room, the ballroom, yeah. That's where you are, and there is like stage closed.
Is there... Directly above the stage, I don't suppose I'm so lucky as to see large chandeliers, something heavy dangling on something.
Oh, 100%.
Thin.
Yeah, I was describing them. They look like celestial creatures, yeah. But they are very high, 50 feet up in the air, because the room has got two, imagine it's 25 feet for each room.
Two floors.
Up. Yeah.
Sure thing. Okay, good. That's good to know. And there's a lot of these celestial creatures just dangling from the roof around, isn't it?
Yeah, it's the shape of it, you know? It's not real creatures. They just shape like angels and kind of like a crystal kind of nice construction. So that is Flair, Errol, and who else? And Bruce?
I think it's just us three going for,
So Flair, Errol,
for the painting.
And Bruce, yeah? And then Ziggy...
Yep.
Ziggy is going to mingle as well as Ruin.
Okay. Ziggy and Ruin mingle.
Like,
would you like to mingle
there,
too,
Yagul?
I'm going to look around a bit, like, where are all the guests going? Like, what's the main event? Is there anything I can do?
Okay. All right, perfect. So let's go one by one. Let's start with you, Yagul, if that's okay with you, as you are kind of like are on your own, kind of. You start speaking to the guests. These guests are friendly, so make a persuasion check at advantage if you kind of like trying to get what is going to be happening on the party. You know, this canapes keep moving around you, kind of like a nice food and stuff like that. And you see now the stage curtain opens and this seems to be a orchestra performing there. There is a guy in an harpsichord, a cellist, a violinist, a flutist, a fiddler. And all of them, there is four waiters now that enter with drinks as well, more drinks. And what did you roll?
A 20.
Yes, sir. Nice, 20. With a 20, you gather that at the moment you're still on canapes and cocktails. There won't be a seated meal, but after this performance of these famous musicians, Quill and the mystery guest will be on the stage, something like that in a few, not in too long. That's why there has been champagne. Everyone wants to be cheering as Quill introduces his friend and stuff.
I want to speak with one of the servants.
Okay, you approach Armando there, wearing no socks.
Armando, okay.
Yeah. No one knows why.
Armando.
Yeah. Ciao. Tutto bene, signore.
Armando, I need your help. No.
What can I do for you?
I will drop the accent.
I'm sticking it up now, sorry.
Well, You're here to make Quill happy as well, right?
That's, I'm just a servant, sir. Yes.
That's it? That's...
Well, a servant who wants to make Quill happy, but Quill is so happy now. So happy. Happy is... That's the way I should say that. He's so happy. So I'm doing my job well.
I'm here to make him happy as well, so...
Oh, nice.
I was wondering if you could get any help with your job, if you have another uniform and for a servant and such, maybe I can help.
Oh, perfect, maybe. Actually, I don't recognize you. Are you from the village? I've been seeing you around.
No, I'm not from the village. I'm from the higher-ups.
What do you mean? The higher-ups.
You know the place where you are originally from? I'm with those people. No, I'm here to make Quill happy. I'm here to make sure that he's happy, you know?
Oh,
I'm,
you come from the outside
basically
world.
Your supervisor somehow.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I love that.
Oh my god, I just realized something. I need these people.
Okay, so... Perfecto. Would you like to be a waiter? Would you like to be helping in the kitchen? Would you like to clean? What would you like to do? I have to go and get your unit for now. You can't do it like this.
Oh yeah, no, I want to be a waiter like you, and I want to serve as your
cleaner. Okay, fantastico. All right. So I'll go and get your uniform, and when you start, what's your name?
I'm Jagu. Fucking, yep.
Oh, Jagu. Oh, I like your name. It sounds like ragu.
I was thinking about like...
Very famous dish from where I come from.
That's what I'm named after.
Wow. Sensationale. Okay. Amazing. So, please don't go anywhere. There's so many guests and you look quite nice. I don't want to be getting you confused, even though you have a shell, right? Is there a shell? Okay. He kind of like scratches his head and kind of goes towards the stairs, towards the upstairs room. Floor.
I will just wait and get dressed as a waiter once he's back and...
Okay, amazing.
We'll be standing around with like drinks, but I won't offer to any of the other guests. I want to keep my like a few drinks on my plate, just in case.
Okay, as Flair, Erold, and Bruce, I'm sorry, I'm gonna do this just for the story's sake. You see a servant kind of running with a purpose, passing by all of you as you kind of starting. Bruce, would you like to try to split? You also hear commotion. It seems to be one suit of armor going down the stairs as well.
You want me to what now? To split? Split
as,
what?
I say, would you like to split and try to go to the other room where you think Rippy Chip is?
Oh, sorry, yeah. Split off. Got you. I thought it was everyone putting something in two there.
No.
Bruce will say to Flair, so, where are you going, Flair? Me and Harold are going this way to get that painting.
Well, I just wanted to see if they would let us leave the room.
Mission accomplished then, I guess.
What's the... Did you say there's one of the armors is running up the stairs?
Is running down.
Running down the stairs?
Yeah.
And
there is a waiter also that he will run up as well. So there is two creatures. The waiter running up with a purpose and a suit of armor animated going down.
I guess Flair will shout after the waiters. Is everything all right? Is there anything we could help with? Anything we make Quill's night better?
He looks at you. No, all okay. All good. Don't worry. You enjoy the party.
Worth it.
You hear the waiter whispers something to the armor as the armor is going down.
You
can make perception checks if you want to try to hear what he says. And Bruce, what are you doing?
Bruce leans in at Flair and goes, are you copying me? And then Bruce will wait. We'll just listen out to see what's going on here before going to that. Is that all right?
Yeah. You hear
28 perception.
You hear two things. You hear clearly the the servant says, "The outsiders are here. I'm going upstairs to inform the master." And then, as that happens, the animated armor mouth opens and does like boom, this kind of sound that kind of like goes like a proper like from a horror movie, and there is a light inside his mouth and like a big siren for a few seconds. What do you guys do as you see that happen?
I guess
the servant
at that point,
keeps
I'm
going
just
running up.
A beeline for the painting, rather. I'm assuming Bruce would have told me what the painting looked like, and I'm just going to make a straight beeline for the painting, and as fast as I can, I guess, try to see if I could take the painting off the wall.
You're going too fast, but sure. You're going towards the painting. Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Bruce, let's see what three of you are doing, and then we move to Siggy. We haven't forgot about.
I mean, they know we're here already, so.
Yeah, so there's no point trying to take out the waiter before warning the master. This alarm's already gone off.
The
as well.
Alarm is at this point, there is music and stuff like that, so it's not fully audible everywhere. You guys are in the middle of the stairs at this point.
Okay, those two are standing right next to each other, the waiter and the armor.
Yeah, the waiter is starting to run upstairs. This is like time has paused because we are out of game deciding what to do. So the waiter is, you see him going running up. The creature is screaming at this point.
Okay, I think.
But there is an opera, music orchestra playing downstairs. Hmm. So.
Flair is going to. So he's been walking with this the white ornate staff that he's got. He's going to, whilst it's still sitting on the ground, he's just going to kind of lengthen his arm and aim it forward towards them and cast Wall of Force.
Okay, as you are about to cast the spell
around both of them,
we're gonna go to Siggy and then we're gonna come back to you guys on roll initiative as you're casting a spell right there.
Yeah, remember, spells take 3 seconds.
However, Siggy, what are you doing? At this point, I'm not gonna make you roll. Yagu and Siggy, you don't hear any, or Ruin, you don't hear any alarm or anything like that. You just hear the orchestra playing crazy, like, you know, there's so many instruments. So,
I think I'm just, Siggy and Ruin are just trying to chat to Jess, like saying, you know, trying to do our best to keep Quill happy, being as automatous as possible with saying that, just like kind of be like, oh, you know, we're doing the same thing as you are. I was like, we should get together and like maybe explore the house, maybe do like a little fun tour and bring him like gifts or memories from what we've done, maybe just do some fun stuff.
Oh wow!
You know, bring our favorite parts of his favorite parts. You know, maybe go exploring. That'd be fun. If it makes Quill happy, just like bringing all of his memories to one place.
Yeah, but you know, we've been told we shouldn't peruse around the house. You know how sensitive Quill can get. You know, we don't want to displease
him. Yes, but it's to make him happy. I mean, a trip down memory lane, wouldn't that be amazing?
I mean, that would be really good, though. I agree with that, but I don't see how exploring the house is going to make him happy, though.
A trip down memory lane.
But he lives here, though.
Yes, but, you know, we don't know how much he gets around.
I mean, it's his house.
He could stick himself in one room.
Make a persuasion check at this apartment.
Aww.
I'm sorry, but it's true. He's like so confused. I see where you're going, so.
Okay, 25. Low roll.
Okay. Amazing.
It was 12. Before you say anything.
Actually,
else,
you know what? Because you will have advantage because this creature is friendly, actually. Let's do a straight roll. Because that will cancel.
Okay, well,
out,
25
actually.
Still, because.
Okay.
The worst roll was the first one.
He says. One of the guests. Okay, but I don't think all the guests should do that. Should you and me do it? And you see that you're talking to this guy.
Oh no, I'm far too busy.
What are you
doing? Like, maybe we can get the armors, the guards, to, like, plan out the best locations. You know.
They only obey Quill. They won't
maybe just
us.
Give them a chat. I mean, you know, maybe just chat to them.
I know, but they are not that kind of creatures, you know, they just...
See, here's the thing.
They're not real, you know. He says to you.
Yeah, but here's the thing. If we gotta make Quill happy, we gotta make everybody involved. So, like, maybe just try and, like, speak to the armors. See what you can get. Basically, I'm trying to get them to distract the armors.
Okay, yeah.
That's basically it.
Okay, so come, show me. I'm not sure what to say. And he kind of, like, grabs your hand. As he grabs your hand, you have a disguise self. Do you try to avoid person grabbing you?
I don't have a disguise self.
Is your changeling, yeah? Okay.
Yeah, it's changeling, okay, sure. Cool.
And your clothes is how it's meant to be and everything, right?
That's just clothes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just clothes.
Yeah, so this person grabs you. Do you allow it to be grabbed by this man? Constructed man, person. He's a guest, right? Just to make sure. Not a waiter.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he kind of like pulls you with a bit of a strength, you know? But they are very cold, the hand. And he says, okay. And he goes towards the stands, you and him, looking at the armor. And he says, okay, you go first. And you see the two armors kind of like dead, not even acknowledging the fact that you're both there. They're just looking towards the painting. What do you say?
Does it get weird? Like, your limbs, do they need to rust? Do they need, like, oil? How does the animated armor work?
They are very magical. You see the plates and stuff are kind of like almost floating half into space.
Do your joint areas become an issue?
Yeah.
What happens if somebody sticks something through there? I'm just starting questions just to piss them off, really.
You see the armors don't react at this point.
Maybe I just do it if you, like, jumps up, just, like, get their attention. Very much like a royal guard situation down at Buckingham Palace. I'm just trying to bother them.
That's what Ziggy's doing. Make an annoyance check. I don't know which performance, I guess.
I'm sure it's performance. It must be performance, yeah.
Yeah.
What damn?
See how much you can annoy this armor.
28.
Fucking hell. I guess you're doing this kind of thing, like, oh, maybe what happens if you kind of put something through there
got
before
your nose.
He answers? You just start poking things through there.
Got your nose.
If you do step too close to those guys, they will draw their, they will, like, point their gun at you and say, step back right now.
Yeah, yeah, no, I say got your nose, and as I do, my finger turns into sort of a metallic bit of metal.
Okay.
It's like, oh, got your nose.
Yeah. One of them kind of makes a sound like super annoying. Like, they kind of, like, one of them seems to be like kind of focusing on you for a second. He's like straight looking at you. You see frustration on their face.
While that's happening, can I Ruin stealthily investigate that painting while I'm trying to distract them?
I'm gonna say, because you have the other armor there as well.
Okay, how about this?
What does he want to do while inspecting? He can look at it. You mean he want to touch it? That's a different story.
Maybe.
Up to you.
Okay, here's the thing. To get the second armor involved, I'll do the gotcha nose thing again, and then put it on the other one and say, oh, look, he's stolen it. It's just to get them both involved.
Make a fate roll, just to see. If you're successful, whatever it was going to happen, it won't happen. If you fail, something will happen.
All right, hi.
Yeah.
Hi.
Okay. You hear an announcement that Quill and his guest star will be appearing shortly, but the curtains don't open yet, and you have enough time to, as you are kind of annoying them together, once more, what do you want to do, Ruin?
Ruin is your attempt to, like, maybe touch the painting or inspect it, but probably touch it.
Okay. So go ahead and make an stealth check. It will be normally a disadvantage because they are right looking at you, but because you are there, Ziggy, I'm going to break the rules a little, and I'm going to say it's a straight roll, even though it shouldn't be.
Okay. Hopefully, I roll well. Oh, fuck, I'm going to use group inspiration. I'm sorry.
Yes, sir.
Fuck, that's not much better.
As you're about to touch it, the arm of the creature. Okay, so slow motion.
1 second.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can I, as a reaction? Oh, wait, shit. No, I've already rolled. So I. Can I use the blessing of the dragon? I don't remember.
From Ruin?
We got a D10 back after we did a thing. Yeah.
We've got a D10 we can just use.
Sure, yeah. It'd be something you can do like that.
I don't think... Yeah, I don't think Ruin has it, but I'll use Ziggy's Blessing of the Dragon.
If you want to use Ziggy's, make a fey roll, because Ziggy's meant to be full engaged distracting, but I will allow your fey roll to be aware of what's happening.
Hi. Fuck.
Well then.
I use it. Okay, I'll see if Ruin has one, sorry.
Yeah, no worries.
No, he does.
I think it's somewhere here. Actually, I think, well, he was with us, so I'm sure he would have it.
Yeah, because he was with us when we returned back to Miriam, I think her name was, the dragon.
Yeah, I don't think he has it, like, marked down anywhere, so I don't want to...
Yeah, let's say he should have it, okay.
Yeah, okay. Then I'll add a D10 to the stealth roll, and hopefully we're all fucking well.
Cool.
7. So, 21 on the stealth check.
Okay. With a 21, in a slow motion, as you kind of touch the painting, unaware to you, Ziggy, as you are completely distracted, Ruan vanishes into the painting.
There it is.
That's what you guys
Goodbye,
want.
Fine. It'll be fine. It'll be fine.
Yagu, make a perception check to see if you notice, because you are kind of going around there close by-ish.
Sure. Like, I was playing on kind of like talking with like everyone around except for the group, but sure, maybe I...
Yeah, as you're waiting for your uniform. Kind of.
Oh, we actually probably see him, yeah.
Okay, with a 23, you see the Ruin kind of like going super slow, kind of like doing this thing, like he's going above everything with the hand, kind of like slowly, and he's just like... The creatures are looking, he puts the hand down, and then he just... He touches it for 1 second, and you see it like going like a swirl and going inside.
Oh, typical. Bruce will steal this painting later, probably. Fuck, what do we do now? And I'm just going to try to eyeball Ziggy at this moment as, like, you come over here. And I'm still trying to act like a servant.
Okay. At this moment, as quickly you go, Ziggy, and then the curtain will open with the beholder, and then we'll move to the
Ziggy
other
is...
Okay.
Ziggy has started juggling apples in front of the guards, just trying to piss them off.
Okay. Amazing. You continue. At this point, you notice as well, Ziggy, that Ruin is not there.
Ziggy will think to himself, oh fuck, I hope he's okay. I don't want to spend money.
Things like, yes.
I don't want to. No, Ziggy's thinking that he doesn't want to spend money bringing somebody back.
Okay. Poor Ruin.
Again.
He's gonna hate me. Okay.
We'll do it later.
Cool. That's a story for a different time. So, who wants to go first? Who wants to go next? What do you guys want to do? Let's between you players do decide who wants to do what.
I know Bruce and Flair were gonna deal with whatever was going on with them running.
So at this point, is the three of you are together, but you could go down the stairs if you want to, Errol, and split with them. From them.
I mean, my thing is, I was gonna still make a book it for the painting that Bruce told me about to try to get to it, but...
Yeah, you could try to do that. The creature, the armor will you... if you try to run, the creature will try to grab you. So it will be... I would say that could be out of combat as using the destruction of Flair starting to cast a spell, you could try to go and try to make an acrobatics checks as the armor tries to grab you as you try to get.
Okay.
I will roll it on the open just to make it more exciting.
And is it alright if I use a quick group inspiration?
Yeah.
Go for it.
Do it.
Okay, acrobatics. Let's try this again. There we go.
Nice.
Once, whoa, look at that. Yeah, as the armor tries to grab you, you fly woof, from its grasp and kind of vanish, going down.
Right.
At this point, yep. Let's do it then. Let's get an initiative up. Let me give you a map and all that, and then we can do that. Oh, actually, let's do the Errol scene first, if you guys are okay. Are you okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
Hold him, guys.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
So let's do that then quickly. So Errol, you kind of go down. You go into the hall. You know the room where you are meant to be going is at this point barricade, but this kind of court and some kind of stand that you could potentially move. There is no one around. As you go down, you hear people clapping. And the music has stopped as well, and you kind of look into the room and you see everyone looking towards the stage.
I'm going to use my I should probably save that for in case. Actually, you know what? I don't have my bow or anything out, so it's going to take me too long. So I'm going to use my I think it's a bonus action to use my ethereal step.
Okay.
So I'll post that right here. And as a bonus action, I'm basically gonna be ethereal for about 6 seconds.
Okay.
And basically just run through the barricade, and just because I should be able to phase through walls and everything.
Okay.
And get to right where the painting is. I'm assuming it's gonna end right when I get to it, but
yeah. Okay, perfect. So as you kind of like go through the wall, it feels like super unusual as you see the ethereal realm. That's where you are actually, in the ethereal plane, right?
Yeah, basically, yeah.
Yeah, everything is kind of like gray and ashes floating around, and everything looks dilapidated and old as you go through there, and you feel very... It's not the first time you do it. You enter and storm into this room through the wall. Your body feels unusual as you do that. And you see this lounge, warm, that smells like wood smoke. You see that there's a fire on, furniture, plush and inviting, chairs, couches, arranged for conversation. And then on the wall, you see a large painting of a forest. The fireplace is crackling. On the corner, there is like a stone statue of a beautiful woman, kind of in a heroic, performative pose, if that makes sense. And you see the painting as well.
So is there any way that I could use my action to basically do some sort of magical check of what Errol knows, whether to get Reapy Cheap out, I would have to go in, or whether I'm allowed to just take the painting off and put it in the bag of holding?
Something,
is there a way I can figure that out?
Actually, this is a bit harder because this is something you've never seen before. So I think the only way for you to do that is to try, actually. You have a few seconds. You are still on the ethereal plane. Mm-hmm. 6 seconds.
Is that the case?
Yeah.
I'm going to use my action while in the ethereal plane,
Okay. Dig
into my bag of holding, take out my dragon wing longbow and just have it out, because it takes an action to take an item out.
Okay. All right. So,
I'm going to have my dragon wing longbow on me now, put my bag of holding away. When the ethereal plane ends, I'm gonna take the painting.
Okay, as you are in the room and you appear in the room, mm-hmm. and you try to go towards the painting, the statue of this woman reaches her hand and tries to slap you on the face. That will be another initiative going there, as it seems to animate itself on time.
So I'll just make a separate initiative roll then.
So wait, let's not do an initiative yet. And then Ziggy and Yagu, you are in the room, the curtain opens, and you see this beholder standing there, floating, with a man that seems to be quite handsome next to him. You don't have a you have a description of how Quill looks like, and you recognize him to be Quill, actually. I'm not sure if you're gonna be able to see this, but I'll show you how this looks like. Yeah, I think that should show it seeing, for everyone.
Seeing that, basically, he will just kind of go to like some phone banister and pretend as if he's just kind of infatuated with Quill. Is like, oh, hi, Quill, sort of like a hi Barbie, hi Ken situation. I haven't seen the Barbie.
So they are on a stage a little bit higher up, as you kind of see that. And you kind of say hi, Quill, and kind of do the hunt, right? Thing?
Yeah, just try and like start a thing going.
What about you, Yago?
Trying to get like everybody to say it.
Okay. What do you want everyone to say again, Ziggy? Just quickly.
Hi, Quill.
Yeah, okay. Perfect. Yeah, people repeat it. And Yago, do you do anything as you see this picture?
I'm not sure. I'm still standing there as a waiter. I'm trying to look like
as you are at this point, make a perception check. As the sound, you are closer to the door. You're kind of waiting awkwardly between the door and the entrance, so make a perception check to see. You won't see Errol because he was on the ethereal plane.
24.
With a 24, you do hear a sound of an alarm, like a woo, kind of like a high pitch one note sound. The door of the place is open on the where you are. And that's where you're standing, and you hear also words of a spell about to be cast. Kind of like words of power. Oh, you don't recognize, it's not good enough to recognize the voice, but you recognize the incantation.
I really hope I get a chance to catch the guy first.
Yeah, no, we're going right to you. I'm sorry for doing this, guys. I'm just trying to make it bind into everyone going as in much trouble as possible, and then we're going to roll
initiative. I'm praying out loud.
I'm so sorry. I hate this to do this, guys. It feels weird. But, Yago, what do you do?
Still nothing.
So, yeah, there is no guy coming. At this point, you start to think to yourself that you told him that you are from outside, and you didn't really take any time to think and try to read his reaction, but perhaps that was something that maybe he's not getting your uniform, it's taking a bit too long. And now the fact that you hear a spell casting sounds like something could have gone wrong there. This is like seconds, you know?
But like, Yeah, I know, but the Mind Flayer and the other dudes are upstage, right?
Yeah, they are on the stage. At this point, Quill starts to talk, and he says, starts to say, everyone, this is my friend, welcome to the party, blah, blah, blah. And he starts kind of like saying a few words. He's coming with us, he's become one of my best friends, and he just keeps going, and you see the beholder is smiling next to him. But they are on a stage higher up, and you are on the door, so it would be a bit of a bit to get in through the people. You could do it. It's not a straight one, kind of.
Yeah.
And Ziggy, and who wants to go first while you think of this, or what do you guys want to do? You tell me, guys. You tell me who goes first and what does it do.
I think Ross had a good plan of blocking the people running with a wall of force, right?
Yeah, can we try and stop them?
That's why
he
could just go first.
That's why I asked if the armor was still standing right next to the waiter, because it's a 10 foot 10 foot by 10 foot.
Okay. So by doing that, you wanna
catch them in, so I can get both of them.
Okay. Let's say yes, because I'm an easy person. But you will have to roll initiative to see who acts first. You will have, we'll give you advantage on this occasion. I don't like doing that, but it feels right. as you kind of initiating this, and Errol managed to escape, so let's do it based on that.
Okay.
You have advantage on initiative, so this will be an initiative between the three of you. So Bruce, what are you don't know whether the wall is going through or not, but you feel that this is getting there is no way to escape an encounter here, but just to get you ready, so roll initiative as well. I'll give you a map now.
Yeah, Bruce is going to rush forward and try and knock out the waiter and then turn to the armor and sort of deal with that.
Okay, so let me take this picture off here. And now you're not going to see anything because this is completely hidden. So let me put your tokens there, so that way.
Of all the fucking times.
Oh, no. So yes,
I'm going to roll my D8 from the Gift of Alacrity.
That's a permanent D8, by the way. Like, just constantly have it for every initiative in those 8 hours.
Ooh, yeah, nice. So I'm going to use it.
Okay.
So, do I also roll with advantage for my initiative? Or am I not rolling yet?
With advantage on your case, you were not really initiating anything. You were about to pick up the painting, so you know what? Sure, yeah, because you appear, you surprise the creature. Sure, you roll with advantage too.
Okay.
1 second, let me get Jagu's token. You are here, Jagu. There, on the door. Then we have Ziggy is here inside. Then we have Moonbear. Let's say you guys are. Let's see the physicality, if it's gonna be better if you are up or down. Yeah, let's say you are. Let's go. Let's say that they go. Okay, I don't understand this. Okay, sure. Let's say they are here. Okay, perfect. And you are. Let's say, just to keep everyone on the same floor, you're on the bottom floor part of the stairs. That is will be halfway through. Errol, you're inside there with the creature that I'm gonna reveal in a second. And then I'm just missing Bruce. And
I got a 14. Flare. I used that Gift of Alacrity thing.
Okay, amazing. So at this point, everyone.
My rule 20 is just gone blank.
Oh, really?
No, sorry.
Maybe you don't have authorization. Yeah. No, let me just make sure.
No, I've got it.
Yeah, okay. Now you guys should be able to see bits, at least.
Mm-hmm. I'm at 22. I need to roll something else to get it back up. Thank God I didn't roll that.
Revealings here. Yeah. 1 quick second. This is the beholder. There is difficult terrain around him because this is there is people all around there as well, and that's what this beauty looks like. Yep, you should guys see that one there, hopefully. Okay, and let's leave him like that for now, and he's up here. Wheel, yeah, too. Perfect. Wheel. Let's forget that wheel and that for now. We go here. So, the armor. Bolt initiative 2. They are here. Let's say that they are on the top here. Let's make it make sense. Perfect. Roll. Roll. My rolls? I don't know what's happening to my roll 22. Okay, so you see that, they roll a 5, so you're going first, okay. Cool.
What about the waiter?
Yeah, the waiter, I'm going to put him...
The waiter was standing next to him.
Yeah, the waiter was standing next to him. Let's say that the waiter is this person here. And he's going to have initiative too. Here, so also gonna roll initiative. Okay, here we go. Perfect. Okay, so yep, similar, almost 5 and a 6. Okay, not very well.
Well, they won't be expecting us, that's for sure.
Perfect. So, based on that, everyone actually... Oh, damn it. So, what will do you want at this point? Just roll initiative, Siggy and Yago, even though just for your turns. It's okay.
What a fucking waste.
Who did shit? Woo!
Wow.
Yeah,
look
but
at
what
that.
A fucking waste. Actually, speaking of, where's Ruin in this situation?
Ruin is not.
Isn't he with you guys?
He's inside
well, he's
painting.
In another painting.
Yeah, he's.
Yeah,
in
yeah. So I don't need to roll for him. I'm just making sure.
And this creature that you see what it is now rolled initiative 2. Damn. Cool. Get all the bad rolls out of the way, please.
Okay. Yeah,
were
these
that's
rolls when
two.
We fucking need them?
That's a 2. Nice. Okay, perfect. Alright. Everyone rolled. Yago, everyone. Perfect. Okay, so... Ziggy, let's... For now, nothing really is happening where you are. You want to do something? Or are you okay?
No, no, just kind of... causing people to like kind of I don't know keep the live going. I'm trying to make myself seem like an NPC.
Yeah, okay, perfect. Okay. No, you're doing really well. Okay.
Fine cool. Day for fishing.
That works fine. Okay. Yeah.
Ziggy is trying to like keep the crowd like focused on one point, I guess.
Yeah. Okay. Perfect, yeah. Everyone seems to be completely focused at this point on the words of what is happening, you know what I mean? Like, on the performance itself. But yeah, they like what you're saying and people are listening to you and stuff too. Okay, it's going well. Now, if you are happy with that, we move to, let's say this is where the painting is. Yeah. So Errol, so who's go first? So next up, Flair, what would you like to do? You are casting that spell still, or you want to change your action? You're on mute.
Ross?
Oh, no. Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, it's your turn.
Yeah.
Sorry. Nice. Yes. I wanted to wall of force around the two on the stairs above us and... silence them in a sphere so that they don't have any potentially softer surfaces to punch through.
Okay, perfect. So please display the spell for us.
Absolutely. See, it's via the Staff of Power, but it uses my whatnots. Display in BTT.
Okay.
And there is no save for this. Nice. It is it's a quarter inch thick wall that lasts for the duration, which is 10 minutes.
It works like what the Wall of Ice spell does, or similar.
Yeah, perfect.
Once I've cast that, if we're staying, are we staying in initiative? So we're actually going to go through all the rest of action economy?
I believe so.
Initiative. Yeah.
Okay, then... for my bonus action, then...
Also, just to clarify, before you fully cast the spell, this spell will block your access to the upstairs floor. I just want to make sure you are aware of that before you fully cast it. If you want to get both of them.
Yes, that's fair, but this is the only way that we stay under the radar at all. So I think we'll try it anyway. And then I'm going to start the blade song. So just by reaching round his back and touching the hilt of the rapier that he's hidden, you'll run one claw up the side of it, and it makes that kind of metal kind of tuning fork ping and hum, and it starts to very gently hum, and the blade song has begun. Ooh, for him. He gains 5 to AC, his walking speed increases by 10, he's got advantage on acrobatics, and he's got plus 5 to any con saving throw to maintain my concentration. Ooh, on something like Wall of Force. So he's then going to move back into the opening for the door, so just enough so he can see what's going on.
Okay, perfect. Alright, so you go back down then, yeah?
I'll go back down to just maybe... Yeah. Oh, okay. I can't really see where the stage is from here, but somewhere like here, yeah.
Yep, perfect. Okay, from there you have line of sight only of the last little square here. I just want to clarify for you, but you know where the stage are, unless you want to move more.
Yeah, the stage is around here somewhere.
No, it's this, yeah.
We've got the light thing on, so I can't see it.
You don't see where you're being. Okay, here. This is the stage.
No, but I can see Yogu and where he's standing. So
yeah, can you see the pin now,
does.
Actually?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, so this is the stage up here. Then.
Yeah. And Flare will say to Bruce, I can hold them here, but it won't last forever. If there's somebody you're trying to save, I would get to it.
Righto. My turn then? Or no, it's Errol's turn.
It's my turn, yeah.
Yeah. After that, if you finish, we move to Errol. Errol, sorry, you're done, Blair?
Indeed.
Okay, perfect. So, Errol, you are faster than the creature. Well, you still have more things that you could do. So, we'll be grabbing the painting the first thing you do, or is it some? Or you want to change the order you do things now, knowing what's happening? Because this creature is going to attack you. Yeah,
so seeing that this thing's attacking me, Errol's thinking back to himself the last construct that basically just screamed. He's realizing this thing's probably going to alert whatever's going on. So rather than grab the painting, I'm just going to go full into action economy. Bonus action, Errol's going to mark this creature with a planar warrior.
Ooh, nice.
So that's going to be on this creature. Errol is going to have his bow equipped as he did so during his ethereal planeness. And Errol is going to teleport 10 feet using distance strike. And he's going to immediately fire off 2 shots on this creature.
Okay, perfect.
I'm going to make the first one sharpshooter just to see if it works.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah, so planar warrior should be on, and sharpshooter should be on as well. And like I said, Errol is trying to get this thing killed quickly. It should be a normal... Actually, could I use a group inspiration to try to make this at advantage? Or I could use my own personal... Okay, thank you.
3 left, I think.
That's gonna miss either way.
Clonk, clonk.
Yep, so sharpshooter, not the best idea. I'm gonna have to turn that off, but planar warrior should still work because it'll be basically on hit, so I'm gonna take a second shot at him.
Okay, perfect.
Normal roll this time because I don't wanna waste all the group inspirations. Does a 19 hit him?
A 19 definitely hits, yes. Yay.
So with that damage, I'm also going to add favored foe, which does activate on hit. That's an extra d6, which I'll roll right now. Damn it. So that's 35 total force damage to him.
Okay. Say it again. Sorry, I just missed it.
What? 35 force damage.
Wow.
For that shot.
35 force damage. Yeah.
Yeah, because the bow plus the acid, right? It's all force, but the planar warrior added 13.
Okay.
So, yep, 35 force. And that's all I could do for my turn. That's it.
Okay. Amazing. Cool. As you're there standing, this kind of like creature you see, like, whoa, the kind of statue is like looking so angry, you know, and you see his mouth starts to open in slow motion as well, much further than it should. And then we move to you, Bruce, if you finish Herald.
Yep.
Cool. Mr. Mumber, right. As you see this force on wall, actually, whenever, let's say that I'll draw it, but yeah, you'll see that.
It's fine. So Bruce will, seeing that this is in hand, he'll look at Flay, he'll nod, and he's going to go 5, 10, 15. Where's the room that Erald and the painting are in?
Is the room here.
Yes.
Yeah,
right.
That one.
Yeah.
25, 30, 35, 40. God damn it.
Keep in mind there's a barrier. I didn't take it down, so that's something you're going to have to deal with.
The barrier is into the door.
Yeah,
no, that's
you...
exactly why I had to go into the ethereals, because I couldn't just walk in, to my understanding.
Right.
I have to take a second.
In that case, can I kick in the door?
You can certainly try. I will say, to be nice, that could be one of your attacks. So go ahead and make, but instead of making an attack roll, go ahead and make an strain. Okay, good. 1 second. Let me just check, because it's actually written here on the module that is a certain way of doing it.
Your thing, boss.
Yeah, 1 second.
He needs to get in. So it's like, well, I can't go ethereal, so I'm gonna kick this thing in.
No, I love that. That's very.
I'll make the door
ethereal.
Strength athletics check. Yeah. So make an athletics check, please. As one of your attacks. Let's say there's a 20-24 an arm strike. Or... yeah.
28.
Yeah, boom. The shards of the door kind of disintegrate, and you hit it at this point. Make a fair roll as well to see more people hit it.
Hi. Well, we're made.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, no worries. Yeah, you keep going. Whatever you're doing.
I can't. I've used an attack, so I can't dash. That's as far as I can go.
Can you throw something at it? You could see it from where you're at.
Well, I need to be allowed to see it, because right now it's still dark. I could stuck myself here.
Yeah. Let's say you can see, because there is a fireplace. It's just the mechanics of Roll 20. So
yeah.
Let's say you're inside.
Are you okay? Do you want me to stand outside the room, or do you want me to stand inside?
Just
the
room? Go inside for now, so you can see what you're doing, and then when you finish your turn, we'll say that you are where you were. To start with. That's
okay. In that case, then I'll see the big fell over there. I would like to rage, regular rage, and I'll throw something at it.
Ooh,
yeah,
nice.
I'm gonna throw. No, I can't. I've given all my weapons away. Could I have kept my sling? Since that's just like a strip of cloth, essentially.
Yeah, definitely. No one. They didn't really search you or anything like that. So.
Because I did put all my weapons apart from Gut Wrencher, and I'm saying the sling
fine.
Away.
It's a small, so definitely.
Mm-hmm. So I'll. It's just a regular go at this then.
Okay.
Oh, 25.
With a 25, as you kind of like with the sling, bang, you kind of hit the creature, roll damage.
Four.
Oh no.
Stone bounces off it.
And is it magical, actually?
Not even slightly, is it? It's just a little stone and a strip of cloth.
Yeah, as you hit this creature, as you might have expected, it hits. And then you see that it's not making any wound at all. Almost like this, the the structure of this creature is too strong for that, what it seems to be a non-magical thing. I'll give you that for free.
Well, bugger. I mean, above game, I knew stone golems are immune to non-magic attacks.
No, David, and your life here tonight, Andy.
Yeah, take a point.
Goliath wasn't made of stone.
That was very, very uncharacteristic. Yeah, well,
Goliath was made up entirely.
Yeah, well, David wasn't a half orc.
Yeah. So, personal inspiration. And what else do you want to do? Come on, let's go. Let's go.
That's everything.
Okay.
That's everything.
That's everything. And you move back.
What do you mean, let's go? I was much faster than those last two.
No, no, I'm just saying. I'm not criticizing anyone. I'm just saying I want to get a couple of rounds, hopefully. Cool. All right, so that's Bruce done, and you stay there where you are. Amazing. Yagu, you are next. With your perception check, rolling on that, you hear commotion coming from the room adjacent to you as well, that there was no commotion there before, and you kind of like, you didn't see, but now you saw Bruce kind of barging into the room. The speech keeps going. What would you like to do? The doors are open. This could be the perfect opportunity for you to shut the doors if you don't want people to hear inside, but that would mean you will block Ziggy. So what would you like to do?
Can I, like, I want to stay in the same room as the Mind Flayer and
the
other dudes,
beholder,
but I will kind of shut the door and I will stand in front of
it
like I'm a
Mind
guard.
Flayer in here as well? Oh, no.
That's the kind of the important part.
Yeah, that... Quill, the secret of Quill has been revealed. I will make him a Mind Flayer for next week. Thank you for that.
Ah, Mark. Crap.
Two Mind Flayers.
Yeah, now you have a Mind Flayer and a Beholder. Okay, go ahead. So what would you like to do exactly? So you want to do the interaction to shut the door, yeah?
Yep, I will shut the door and kind of stand in front of it as a guard. But I guess I will hold my action to shoot my ring of shooting stars at anyone who I seem fit to get shot at,
okay.
I guess.
Perfect. And you want to hold the barricade the door from the outside to make sure no one goes in.
Yeah, so no one hears the rumpus that the rest of the crew is doing. Like, I trust them.
Do you kind of do any signs to Ziggy or something, who is kind of probably, I will imagine, you will be keeping an eye what's happening with you, because you guys are always
doing
he's that.
Doing a good job. I don't want to distract him.
All right, perfect.
As long as he is keeping them distracted, we're okay. Like, as long as they don't join the fight, we're okay, I think.
You hear Ziggy say, "Let's get some fucking shots in!" And he'll start getting everyone to start drinking.
Yeah!
Okay, perfect. Cool. Then after Yagu's turn, we move to this guy here. You're not gonna believe this, but yeah. Give one second. Yeah, perfect. Damien is within this force wall. There is nothing he can do. He screams, Does he make a save? Does he do anything? He's just stuck there, right?
He's just stuck there, and actually, I don't even know if we hear him.
So the thing is, like, a few feet, it doesn't say anything about sound. However, it's immune to all damage and can't be dispelled.
Nice.
So he's kind of fucked.
Yeah.
He's stuck there for 10 minutes.
Yeah, let's hope
until concentration runs out.
Yeah, so
that sucks for him.
Yeah, he screams kind of like aggressively, really angry. The animated armor keeps punching the wall, not knowing or having much of a brain. He keeps trying to do like a goldfish every 3 seconds he tries to go through, kind of thing. But yeah, and that will be that. The stone golem from inside the room. Actually, animated armor. Nothing. Perfect. A stone golem from inside the room, as he will continue to open its mouth more and more and more. Woo! And you hear this kind of wooing, kind of weird sound. I need Bruce and Errol to make a wisdom saving throw, please. Actually, sorry. We'll move here first and then do that.
I'm gonna use a personal inspiration for this one, because my wisdom saving throws are kind of not so much. So wisdom saving throw advantage. There we go.
Wow,
look at that.
Proficiency in wisdom?
They don't.
Oh.
Yeah, amazing. You are successful. And both of you, yeah, you managed to overcome the slow that this creature was doing on you. But that is out of actions for them now, after that.
I failed to kill it in a turn, I'm sorry, guys.
No. I mean, there are stone golems. I'll be surprised if you kill in one turn. But don't worry, you're gonna have more to kill, because from this room, Yagu, your attack will trigger as the door barges in and another stone golem comes running towards, going towards the room where the others are. That is being just broken into 100 pieces. You have an opportunity to attack at this point. He seems to ignore you, your presence.
Am I in view of like the Mind Flayer and such? Are they that distracted, or can
no,
I?
You close the door. Get away with so they don't see you. You are. There is no line of sight for you in there anymore.
I guess in that case.
So this creature came from the room that you cannot see. Now that the door is smashed, you see it seems to be some kind of lounge. Let me just make sure. A dining room. Yeah, there is a fully set up dining room with a table and everything. Go ahead.
In that case, I will use my fairy fire on it.
Ooh.
Which will basically just cast fairy fire.
Ooh. Okay.
On it.
Amazing.
Not that impressive.
No, that's pretty good. I believe it's a save, right? Of some sort.
Yes. Okay. It's a dex save.
Dex. Oh no. Bless his heart. Okay. They have advantage though, that's the good thing. He rolled a 0 and an 8. So 8 will take.
I get the impression stone golems not very dexterous.
Yeah, it's kind of like they look beautiful and they are regal, and these stone golems are kind of skinny even though they are large. But yeah, definitely not stealthy, not dexterous. Yeah, and yeah, cool. So it's under that. So remember, I'll put a little wiggly bit so we remember, hopefully. And this one is, let's put a pink one. Yeah, okay, this one. Okay. Yeah, put a heart. Perfect. And that's your reaction. You have Warcaster, or you were holding that spell, right? Yeah, let's say. I'm not sure.
Either I was one. Holding.
Okay, perfect.
I was holding the ring to use the ring.
Yeah.
Whenever I.
Yeah, amazing. And then the creature will keep going. The movement is. Oh, okay. So. Six, and from this door, Bruce, he's going. You feel like this creature just comes out of nowhere, ignores Flare, and he goes towards you with a punch and tries to smack you with a 24.
Oh, he punched him in the back of the head. Ow!
Yeah,
You cheeky bastard!
Yeah, with a 24 to hit.
You cheeky little boy.
Let me roll it. Okay, so you.
You're raging.
I am raging.
Yeah. Okay, oh, that's good. 13 plus 6, 19 points of damage, average.
Okay, yep. That's down to 9?
Yep, sir. And then.
Oh, bam! Will... Oh, son of a bitch!
Yeah, as you hear that, another one comes your way. Second attack, fucking hell, 19 to hit.
I turn around just in time for him to clock me again in the chin. Yeah.
And this will be 22 plus 6, that's higher, 28 points of damage. Reduced to 14. Okay.
Ow.
Yeah, and that will finish the turn. Also, something I forgot. Yagu, make a quick perception check as the door bursts open and there is light inside, even though you don't see it on the map because roll 20 is annoying.
Not a perception check from the ghoul.
Yes. Aww.
I use group inspiration that we probably still have.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the last one. Yep.
18.
You see there is another painting that looks mysterious and hanging on the dining room that you just been burst open.
I have to touch that later.
And this one.
Thank God, Lee, you said later.
This one looks of, as you look at it, it's kind of like it definitely makes sense. Yagu, I should like give you advantage on the check. So forget, put the group inspiration back, because this is Yagu's field. It's a banquet full of beautiful foods, painting, kind of like all these foods pouring out. It's just like a huge, unmanageably beautiful and. Something you really would like to ask Yagu, loving food. We are food, so yeah. Cool.
Sure.
All right, so knowing that, let's push for one more. We might have to stop halfway. Ziggy.
Ziggy's going to try and continue, like, just chanting and keeping the group, or at least all the other campmates just sort of occupied.
Okay, let's say make a deception or performance check, whichever one you want to blend in as much as possible. You have advantage, I guess, because you made yourself look like them, right? Okay.
Yeah. Performance just because it's a better modifier.
Okay.
Fuck. Okay, 21.
Yeah, no, that's fantastic.
I rolled a 2 and an 8.
The people are loving you, Ziggy. You're a beautiful. Creature, and everyone wants to just talk to you, and you're kind of like novelty. Someone else will ask you at some point, I haven't seen you around, the same that it happened earlier to Yagu. Are you from Wisteria Vale, or where are you staying?
Oh no, I'm new to the area. I'm here to help out Quinn. Always here to help Quinn.
Oh, okay. To help him how? Tell me more.
Gotta keep the party going, don't we?
Okay. Make a deception check.
Deception.
Yes, sir.
24.
Yeah. Oh, yay! As you say, keep the party going, this person jumps a little bit and kind of keeps clapping, watching the speech. Cool. Anything you like to do apart from that?
Not really. I mean, I guess, am I in the beholder's sight?
There is people around, you know, so everyone is within the sight, but you see that at this point, you can make an inside check if you want as well. If you want to kind of read this, how the body language of the beholder and Quill.
No, not good. 10.
Yeah, I mean, they seem very comfortable. I'll give you that. There doesn't seem to be tension.
I'm just wondering, is my magic still available?
What do you mean?
Well, it's like I can soul cast detect magic if I wanted to in the area.
I mean,
if I wanted to. But I'm just wondering, can I?
I mean, I see where you're going now. I guess you will have known what you know, because you will have shared information of a beholder. So just to avoid the meta, let's see, based on the relaxed demeanor of the beholder, you don't think that there is anything that he's doing to stop magic.
I shouldn't be worried about my anti-magic field.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I'm going to soul cast Tet's magic of the room.
Okay, perfect. Right.
I'm gonna do that and just let me know if I do anything really.
I assume there is no material.
By the way, so I only learned this today, but detect magic is verbal somatic.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Like counterspell, so it can be soul.
Yeah, I love that. Okay. Yeah, with your detect magic on, you gathered on the painting, kind of behind you. Within 30 feet, you gather. I have a list for these things. Transmutation, I think, is the one. School of Transmutation.
I already knew that was something weird.
As well as some kind of anti-divination blocker, as well. This is a bit broken, but I'm giving you that. There's something that is kind of on the painting also to stop divination. As well, there seems to be some kind of other magic that you sense that is some kind of like the one to stop some kind of like a barrier of some sort, potentially, or something like that on it. So there is three different magics on that painting, particularly.
Do I see anything about like the people around? Like, do I see anything on Quill or anything, like a magical item or something like that?
No, the armors are magical as well, obviously magical creatures. There is no other magic detected. Beholder itself is a magical creature, I guess, but there is no magical items or anything like that you detect apart from that.
So, nothing on Quill?
No.
Right, okay. Waste of spell slot, okay.
I mean, it was a good detection. You gather that this painting is very, very well guarded.
Well, I've discovered the magical walking armors are magical.
Yeah,
and I mean, the painting that I know is a magical portal is a magical portal.
Yeah, but the fact that is, I mean, the thing is that you haven't compared them with the other ones, but he's got three spells
next
on
you'll
it.
Tell me, yep, next you'll tell me Australians are from Australia.
Yeah, okay. Anything Sorry. Else?
I guess I'll waste some more magic. No, that's me done.
Okay, cool. After Ziggy, Blair, you keep concentrating on the spell as you see this creature behind you that just appeared out of nowhere. Another stone golem. What would you like to do?
Just, Flair looks around and sees the stone golem coming and smack Bruce and just kind of smiles a big toothy grin and he realizes he's underestimating him. Puts the dread helm back on and begins to shift as he does his shifting.
Nice.
I'm going to have that's a bonus action. I'm going to have to roll 1d6, so 16 plus whatever I roll. Well, that's only one.
Okay,
so
cool.
17 temp HP. My AC goes up again, so I'm now up to 26.
Fuck. Wow. Fucking crazy. Amazing.
Thanks for you actually made that higher with the glamoured. and yes, now that I've done that, the way the shift looks, because he's never done it before, I'll just quickly go into that. It's were tiger descendant, I decided. So his ears get a little bit longer and a little bit furrier, his nose widens. And there's a hint of a snout begins to show. You see that just as the helm's coming down and his mouth widens in a kind of a slightly grotesque grimace with more pointed teeth. His hands get bigger, kind of like paws. And his red hair elongates a bit. And there's darker stripes almost starting to show in the downy fur across his face. He then slowly pulls the long nasty black blade he has out from his back, and he will move toward the stone golem, which I can do because it's 100. The wall of force doesn't seem to require me to stay really close to it.
Perfect.
And he will make two attacks, one of which can be a cantrip. So the first attack will be a booming blade attack.
Okay.
So he goes to hit. Which is thunder damage. He drags the tip along the ground as he flings it up and into the lower quarter of this thing. I need to make the attack with the blade first and see if it lands.
Right. Amazing. Yeah, definitely.
I was saying that while me with it. Is it advantage? Is it fairy fire?
Oh yeah. Very good point.
Oh,
yeah,
excellent
yeah. Actually,
point.
Yes, you have advantage because that. Thank you.
I did not think of that. Thank you very much. Just as well, really. 20 to hit.
Okay, with a 20, definitely hits. Yay!
Right, this is where it starts getting a little bit screwy, so bear with me. We have normal stabby damage, or it's magical piercing, I suppose.
Okay,
which is...
Well, that's perfect.
And there's sneak attack on it. 2d6.
Nice.
I only have to be within 5 feet of it. Nobody else is. So it's 22 regular piercing. Then we've got the booming blade damage, which at 11th level is 2d8 up front and 3d8 if he moves.
If he moves, yeah, okay, amazing.
So it's another 7.
Okay, so total of 29.
Of thunder damage. And I'm afraid we're not finished.
Oh.
And it's 1d4 necrotic, and I need you to make a DC 15 con save.
Okay, 1 second, let me just do this damage first. Okay, awesome. And and he needs to make a con save against against what?
Getting DC 15.
Okay. He's got a lot of thingies, so what will he do if he fails? Let's roll it and then we'll see. He got a 9.
If he fails, he is wounded.
Ooh.
I've called it the Stolen Scale Blade, but it is a Rapier of Wounding.
Oh.
You cannot magically heal from any damage this weapon has inflicted, so this is short of a long rest. So
amazing.
He stays hurt. And you're now wounded once, which means you're going to take an extra d4 of this, and it starts to snowball every round until you make the save.
Oh, that's amazing. Cool.
So yeah. That's the first attack.
Nice.
Second attack is a more regular one where we just swing again, 24 to hit.
24 definitely also hits. You have advantage, so roll again. It could be a natural 20.
So I do. Sorry. It's putting the sneak attack on. No, it's not. It's 21 to hit this time. So it's actually not 7 sneak. So it is. Adding all this extra shit without my knowing. And you need to make the DC 15 con save again.
Again, okay. So
every time I hit. Well, is it once per round or is it every time I hit you actually?
I don't know.
For each time you wound it.
I guess if it's already has it.
Of the wounded creature's turns.
Yeah, but if it's already has it.
No, that's it.
Yeah. Okay. 8. Yeah.
Yeah.
On the second one.
7. I don't think I get to do the necrotic twice.
Okay, perfect. 7. Perfecto.
And that is all I get to do here.
Right.
However, I will then move back over here, which I can do without provoking opportunity attacks because of the rogue swashbuckler element. And
nice.
I'm just going to stand here and hope you can't get to me.
Okay, awesome. I love that. And then we're gonna do the last turn with Errol and then we end it, okay? So if that's okay with everyone.
Right.
Unless you guys, think so. Yeah, it's getting really late. So Errol, up next.
Right, so bonus action on the same creature I've been attacking. I'm gonna do Planar Warrior, so I'm gonna post that again really quickly. Should be right here. Here it is, so. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
And first shot is gonna be just a normal shot. It's not gonna be sharpshootered.
Okay.
Okay, so there it is. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna take a risk. I'm gonna use an inspiration. I'm gonna make this one sharpshooter. A personal inspiration.
Perfect. Yeah.
Do we not have any? We have some of these.
We definitely have at least one left.
Yeah.
Alright, then I'll just use the group one if that's okay.
Mm-hmm.
And with that one, just gonna make sure everything is on. So, yep. Okay. And advantage. I hope I hit. That might actually hit. Dirty 20.
Oh, dirty 20 definitely hits. Yeah.
Alright, so he's gonna take 11, 3, 2, 11, 10. 37 for that shot.
Fucking hell, 37 points of damage.
And it's all force.
And he's all force, yeah, okay, perfect. Yeah, cracks start appeared, but not bloodied yet.
And then the second shot is gonna be a normal, regular shot.
Okay, perfect.
The dirty 20. For 10 total damage, 9 piercing, 1 acid.
Okay, perfect.
And that's all I can do.
Cool, cool. 1 second. I'll do the damage. Do you guys want a cliffhanger that will be spoilery, or do you want to keep it fully surprise?
Up to you guys. It doesn't. It's fine with me either way.
Surprises are fun.
Okay. As before we finish, then let's do it. Okay. I love spoilers.
I was about to say, is it to do with Ruin? Because he hasn't done anything.
Yeah,
I'll let Lucky know.
Yeah. Okay. So as Ruin goes into this painting, he finds himself in some kind of in a chase long. I'm not actually sure what that means. Chase long is this, actually.
It's a kind of a city, isn't it?
Huh?
It's a shrink's couch.
Ah, okay. Yeah, all right. So he finds himself sitting there, reading a book that he's holding for the library. And in there, you see Arant Quill as Ruin enters. And that's where we're going to end it for tonight's session. As Ruin looks at this creature, the creature smiles and sees so much happiness on his face. As he looks a little bit, he looks fine. But a little bit, his clothes are a bit like dirty, like he doesn't seem to be changing or washing often. He seems to be a bit mucky, that little expression. And yeah.
Can Ruin like make quick insight? He's like, is this man a prisoner?
He doesn't need to make an insight. He is a prisoner, okay. Based on...
Right, so just so I can put it in the notes.
Yeah. And with that, we will end tonight's session. Wow, okay, thank you so much for my amazing players. Thank you, Luke, Ross, Mark, Andy, and Joey. Thanks for all of you who are watching from home. Thanks to Darren Curtis, Tessa Presents, Tabletop Audio, James Webster, and to all of you who watch us every week. We will see you again tomorrow and Sunday, hopefully. So until then, look after yourself and stay magical, and good night. Bye-bye.
Very cool.